is the Monday edition. The welcome back, Tausch. We missed you. It's great to have... Whoa, that's an April Fool's joke. Sorry, he's not here yet.
Edition.
The Gary Ellerson is like the Cal Ripken of Cousin Subs edition. The... You know, Jesse, we had, I don't know if this was when you were producing or if it was with your predecessor, Tony Cartagena, but we once had Christian Laettner on the show, and I had disliked him for years, and then he was on the show, and he proved to be actually very likable. I don't know, we should get him back, because now I feel that way about Filipowski, and I really enjoyed seeing Duke lose yesterday edition. Who else do you root against? Because I don't usually root against anybody except maybe Devondre Campbell. And I...
Oh, my God.
Now, I didn't root against him. That was a joke. But don't start making a thing out of this.
Well, you know it's April Fool's Day, too.
Yeah, that one... I did not enjoy my time covering him, but I did not root against him. Edition. I'm Wildy and Tausch. On 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee, 100.5 ESPN Madison, 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam, ESPNWisconsin.com, the ESPN app, your Alexa smart speaker, streaming live video, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and of course everything you need on WisconsinOnDemand.com and the Wisconsin On Demand app. I am Jason Wildy in Green Bay. Jesse Nelson, the aforementioned Jesse Nelson, is in the Everlight Solar ESPN Madison studios. And from his own undisclosed location, it is Cal Ripken. Four consecutive Wildy and Tausch Cousin subbing appearances. And this poor man did two of them with Jesse all by himself. It is the great Gary Ellerson, our Cousin Sub of the day. Gary, good morning. How are you?
Hey, good morning. Doing well. How was your vacation?
It was good. I got a lot done. Yeah. I didn't really go anywhere. Yeah. The girls went to a water park in the Green Bay area, where they could have also attended a wedding once upon a time, but they didn't because they weren't invited.
Oh,
so we
say.
Didn't attend it either. But it's a lovely, lovely place. It did leave me wondering if Jesse and his beautiful bride, Becca, partook in the water park as part of their honeymoon, since I know their actual honeymoon was postponed because of COVID, right? Did you go to the water park? Did you have your swim shirt on like Tausch?
We did not make it to the water park at said establishment on our wedding weekend. Rumor had it some of the guests did, but we did not, no.
After probably drinking an adult beverage or two.
I think I missed something here.
It's a sore subject, Gary.
Not Tausch? For me. It's not for me.
How would you know?
Well, so did you want the story behind Jesse's bitterness about the Tundra Lodge, or did you want the story behind Tausch, who wears a swim shirt when he goes swimming because he's a modest fellow? That is a Photoshop.
There he is.
That is the concept, generally speaking.
Okay.
On a wrecking ball, because he pendulumed throughout the season. But Jesse got married. How many years ago was that, Jesse? Now.
It was June of 2021, so we're coming up on 3 years.
Wow.
Like yesterday.
I had 2.5, so I should have gone more on Prize Picks. And so Jesse had his wedding here in Green Bay, was nice enough to invite Paula and me, but did not invite the girls, so we did not come. So is that IPT, as Tausch would say? Is that in poor taste that we did not? We didn't just no-show, which I believe Tausch did for the ceremony, if I recall correctly. I consider going to the ceremony but not the reception, which is the best type of guest who comes, brings you a gift, and then you don't have to pay for their meal. But Tausch did come to the reception but not the ceremony, right, Jesse?
That is the case, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, Gary, was it in poor taste of me not to come?
You didn't either?
I didn't come to I sent my regrets that I wouldn't be able to come. And then, like, Sydney had, like, a softball game or something that day, so we weren't going to miss a sporting event to see Jesse walk down the aisle.
Oh, my God.
So it really didn't make a difference if we invited the kids or not. You wouldn't have been there anyway.
It did, because then we would have come to the reception with them. And then we would have gone to the water park. See?
Mm-hmm,
how that works?
Mm-hmm.
But we're happy for you. I got you a gift and I didn't even attend. And your dog Mo loves my blanket.
It was very nice.
Yeah,
of you.
Exactly.
Yep. Yep. Very
Thank
nice.
You, Gary.
Yeah. Okay, that's
God, it's so great to have you. Can you stick around for the rest of the week?
If you got Well, I mean, it's all about a presence to me. I really don't need you there. Just get me something.
We got married in it was a neutral site. It wasn't a home game for either of us. We got married in Green Bay. And okay. Jason, by proximity, Jason was the nearest resident invited to the wedding. Like, it wasn't really close.
Fair.
There was one couple from De Pere that came.
Oh, they might have been closer.
And everyone else was from way out of town. And Jason declined the invitation despite being 5 minutes away.
Respectfully. Yeah. Respectfully. Uh-huh.
Respectfully
it's right by
declined.
All right, so we're happy to have Gary for another day. We don't have to spend any more time reliving the fact that if Jesse would have invited the girls, we would have definitely come to the reception. And instead, we can focus on not April Fools, but the NCAA tournament. We have our Final Four on the men's side. The game of the century, some might say, on the women's side is tonight, Iowa-LSU, a rematch of last year's championship game. The defending champions against Caitlin Clark and the Hawkeyes, who score a lot more than their football team does. We'll get to that. But, Gary, I need to ask you, because you are a nice man.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You're one of the nicer people I know. Now, when you stiff that limo driver back in your rookie year with the Packers and Bob Harlan had to tell you to pay the man,
maybe
that was not as good. But do you root against people or teams? Do you do that?
No, I don't. I really don't. It's too much energy wasted by things like that. And I don't, you know what? I don't even root against the Bears because they're a hated rivalry. I mean, no, I don't. You got other things to do than rooting against someone?
Well, I mean, so I don't. First of all, those who listen to the show regularly know that I don't really root for any teams, not even Oregon. It's more of a connectivity thing. And I root for certain people. And when I watch games, even when I'm watching our girls compete, like I'm not like Domofsky is intense, right? Like his wife gets some candy to suck on, so it reduces the likelihood of him screaming at officials or other parents or whatever.
Oh, you're talking about the high school games.
Yeah, I'm not wired that way. So I just sit. I take pictures. Sometimes I politely clap. But yesterday, Sydney, who is our youngest, who plays basketball, and I watched Duke and North Carolina State.
Right. Uh-huh.
And I have no connection to NC State. I do like DJ Burns. He seems like my kind of player and a really good story. Yeah. This team is a really good story. They had to win 5 games in 5 days to win the ACC tournament. Otherwise, they don't get into this tournament, and now they've won 4 in a row to reach the Final Four. But this Kyle Filipowski guy, he's like a cheap knockoff of Christian Laettner in the 90s. And I have disliked him intently ever since he flopped with was it Wake Forest, Jesse, that the fans rushed the court?
Yep, that's
And
who
he
it
dropped
was.
A shoulder into a fan, and then he pretended that he had torn both ACLs like Michael Irvin at Veterans Stadium in Philly. And it turned out he wasn't injured at all, but he created this whole firestorm of court storming is terrible and this and that. And they played the next game. And he is a weenie. He is a guy that you want. Am I wrong? Is he not a weenie?
Did it Caitlin Clark, Katie Clark, whatever her name is, did she do the same thing?
No, I think she got legit run over by that Ohio State fan.
And then
she said she was fine. Then she said she was fine with court storming. This is not a whataboutism discussion. This is a Filipowski discussion. Jesse, am I alone in hating this guy?
No, especially a month ago, everybody hated this guy. Like,
it's Duke. Everybody hates Duke.
That's the starting point, yeah.
It's
I'm rooting
Duke.
For Con Knipple to do well there.
Insert player Duke.
Yeah, I like Grant Hill.
He's
like Grant Hill.
Most dislikable Duke player since Grayson Allen, maybe.
Ooh,
Filipowski.
Good, Good pull.
Yeah, probably. Probably.
What is it with those guys, man? What is it?
Yeah, I don't know. I think it's the school, and they rub people the wrong way, and they kind of, and he has that look, sort of, kind of, where, you know the look. I can't say it on air, but it's just Duke. People hate Duke. I don't know why.
Hunter Vaughn chiming in. I'm a Duke fan, and I don't like him.
Is that the lovely Hunter Vaughn?
Very lovely.
He's a lovely young man.
Yeah. Handsome. Is that what you called him while I was away?
Yeah.
Lovely?
That is what occurred,
lovely.
Yeah.
He is lovely. He's
the
likeable.
Pride of Berlin. Yeah.
Not new Berlin. Just Berlin? The
no,
old Berlin?
Berlin. Yeah, good the pride know. Of Berlin. Guess where it's at?
West of New Berlin? No.
Oshkosh.
Where is it?
Oshkosh.
Really?
Near Oshkosh.
Yeah. You're now up to speed on what you missed for 2 days.
I thought Green Lake was near Oshkosh. Wasn't that what I learned on Wednesday?
Yeah, everything's near Oshkosh.
That's my understanding. Very central location. So is there anybody, like Jesse, you already hated the Cubs.
Yeah.
But now, because you have decided that you absolutely, positively despise Craig Counsell, that now your hatred burns even hotter. Right.
Oh, yeah. Anytime the Cubs are on national TV this year, I'll be checking in to see if they're losing, and there'll be a grin on my face if I turn it on like the other day and they're down 11-2 in the eighth inning, and Counsell's coming out there to put in a position player.
Why
to throw
do you
some
hate
pitches.
Craig Counsell?
Oh my God!
He dared to leave the Brewers. How dare he?
You can't grow up with your dad working for the team, with being a lifelong resident of the greater area of the team that you're managing and previously played for, never win a championship, then instead of saying I wanted a big payday, say I needed a new challenge in my career. You didn't win the World Series. You didn't make the World Series as a manager, Craig. If you want a new challenge, how about getting to the World Series first in Milwaukee before you move on to something? He's a liar.
So bitter.
Just such a scam that he went to Chicago.
Sorry.
Yes, we're actively rooting against Craig Counsell. Real opening day is around the 4th of July when the Cubs come to town. That's when this thing will pick up. Opening day tomorrow is going to be great. Opening day over the weekend was great. When the Cubs come to town in July, that's going to be that's going to be a big one.
So basically what we've established to start the show is that Gary is a better person than us. That right?
Yeah.
So there's really no arch enemy from your playing days. Like, you played at Wisconsin, man. There had to be rivalries. And that was when Wisconsin was good before things got bad for a long time. No rival.
No.
Nobody you still root against.
No. No. No.
God. Well, okay, this topic's going nowhere. 844-777.
But you're
going
to tell me who you root against, though.
All right, so I root against Duke.
Right. Okay.
I like to see them lose. I have not watched Dynasty, not the old 80s nighttime soap opera that used to be on, I think, after Dallas. Tausch is the Dallas fan here, so I don't know. The one about the Patriots. I enjoyed seeing them lose when they would lose during their domination of the 2000s and 2010s. I don't like to see the Yankees succeed. I always take joy in the Yankees not succeeding. I don't hate the Cubs like Jesse does. I'm trying to think of other like college teams. I don't like Michigan, so I always want to see them be disappointed, and that didn't work out so well. They won the national championship, but nothing as intense as that. This is why I brought it up, is because yesterday was an anomaly for me. Like, I was both rooting for a game I had no connection to for the story, which is what I do generally, and yeah. NC State is a hell of a story, and I mean, I literally said to the television, with Sydney sitting next to me on the couch, when Filipowski fouled out, oh, that's a shame. Bye. See you later. And I mean, I'm doing that in my living room, and I never do that sort of thing. So it was just, it was unusual for me. Jesse, do you have anybody, since Gary is of no use whatsoever because he's such a good person, Do you have anyone else that you root against?
Oh, I've got a list. Yeah, I've got a list. Yeah,
sounds like he does. Both of you guys are petty.
Many of the Chicago teams are near the top of the list. So the Cubs we've well established. The Blackhawks we've well established because of the connection to the inability of Milwaukee to have a hockey team. And the bandwagon fans from when I was in college in Illinois that just jumped on like hockey was invented in 2010. The Seattle Seahawks are fun to root against, although maybe not so much anymore with Pete Carroll and Russell Wilson not there. But for a long time, for them, same thing with the Blackhawks. It's like football was invented in 2011 when the Seahawks burst onto the scene with you know the 12th man and all that stuff. Notre Dame football is full of itself. Michigan and Ohio State are easy to root against. There's some other college teams that are, you know, basing a bunch of pageantry on stuff that happened 30, 40 years ago. Miami, easy to root against. The Hurricanes.
Turnover chain.
Yeah, the Miami Heat have a lot of hateable people, especially when they beat the Bucks. Yeah, there's a bit, the Yankees, the Dodgers, like, we could go on for, there's a long list, but that covers a lot of the top ones that come to mind right away. Cardinals, best fans in baseball.
I was just about to ask
forgot about them.
The Cardinals.
Although I will say that when I was in St. Louis for Arch Matt, they did a really great job with the ballpark. I hated how much, this happened when I went there a few years ago for a game too. I hated how much I enjoyed the experience. And there's a lot of similarities between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Green Bay Packers that I don't like to admit.
There is. You're right.
So
absolutely,
that's one that I respect the Cardinals, even though I still hate them. The other teams I don't really respect. Like, I respect the Cardinals. Like, they're a worthy foe because they win a lot. The other teams, they don't even win that much, but they're just all full of themselves.
Gary, you have to understand that Jesse, I believe one of the confessions he made somewhat early in his tenure of producing the show is that he would watch a game, a baseball game in the middle of June, that he had no interest in otherwise, just to root against the Cubs or the Cardinals, right? Am I remembering this correctly?
For sure, and especially when those two are playing each other, and you're just like, you don't even know what you're rooting for. You just want to hate watch the entire operation.
Yeah. Hate watching, which is different than rooting against.
Yeah, like Duke, Kentucky, when they play each other early, like you're not cheering for anybody in that game. You're just hate watching it. You're like, oh, these guys are pretty good, but oh man, oh.
Well, let me ask you guys this. Who are you rooting for tonight? LSU girls, obviously, or Iowa? Who are you rooting for tonight?
So here,
because that's a huge dilemma here. I'm not going to be on Twitter tonight. I'm going to refrain. I'm going to try to refrain because this game is going to get ugly.
So here's my issue with tonight's game, and I am going to watch it. I am looking forward to it. It is a school night, so we'll see if Sydney stays up for the entirety of it. I had this conversation with Craig Karmazin yesterday on Sunday Karma. I don't dislike LSU's players, but I really, really dislike their coach. I really, really don't like Kim Mulkey. She is, and here's a guy that I couldn't stand, and I thought he was a bully. I don't like bullies. I really don't like bullies. And Kim Mulkey is like Bobby Knight in sequins and feathers to me. Like that, I couldn't stand Bobby Knight. I once asked him a question at a press conference after they beat Steve Yoder and the Badgers in Madison, and his answer was very nice. I dated someone who went to Indiana and really adored Coach Knight. He was a bully, and I hate bullies. And I think she's a bully. And I don't like her at all. And yet, you know, I like their team is really good and really fun to watch. And so I am struggling with how I'm just going to watch the game. I'm not going to root for really anybody. I don't have a strong affinity for Caitlin Clark either. Like, I don't feel strongly like I don't love her like much of America does. I don't dislike her. I just like watching her play basketball. And I don't think the commercial she does is very good, the shoot one. Well, where's the hoop?
Yeah, no. Agreed.
So why are you going to stay off of Twitter is my question. You
well, because I know
like
it's
going
to get contentious. Yeah, I think it's going to get contentious. I'm going to try. I'm going to try not to get on there because it's going to get weird. I just know that. I mean, America today is not what it used to be. I don't want to go into all that, but it's going to get weird because it's really about Angel Reese and Caitlin Clark, which it really shouldn't be, And I think that's what we're going to see. It's nice that I see both of these girls talk in a positive way about each other. But on the outside, mm-hmm. I don't feel that it's that way. You got two girls that are going to be very competitive towards one another, and they both want to win. But I feel like one is seen in a different light than the other, where I think both, in my opinion, are one and the same, meaning that they're both are very competitive and they both want to win, and they'll do whatever it takes to win a ball game.
It will be. I hope it is a great game. That's really all that I'm interested in. I want to be entertain me, as Tausch likes to say,
and I think
tonight that will happen. I referenced Tausch. He is back allegedly tomorrow. That is not a April Fool's joke, but Gary will be.
Do you hear from him? Do you hear from him at all when he's on vacation? Does he text you, "Hey guys, I'm doing okay"? Blah blah blah. Is this just he's gone?
He is in communication. He's like Aaron Rodgers on a darkness retreat.
Off the grid.
I don't even know where he is.
We have no idea. He could be at home. He might be at home, actually. He's off the grid. Not a clue.
All right. Well, and I don't know. Maybe he's not as petty as us either. I feel like maybe there might be a team or two that he roots against, but Gary's no help. So we turn it over to you. 844-770-3776, 844-770-3776. Is there a player or a team that you root against? Yes, we would all like to be better people. I would like to be a better person. I'm constantly striving to be a better person. But yesterday, I was like half a good person yesterday, because I was genuinely rooting for the NC State story. Like, this is the best story they've had since 83 with Jim Valvano, right? So there's no doubt. But I was also taking equal pleasure in Duke losing. That was really nice to see. And especially when the officials, I had flashbacks to Wisconsin-Duke, when the officials called a technical on NC State's coach for stepping out of the coach's box in a crucial moment of the game. So I will admit that I was not a good person. I was rooting against Duke. So this is a judgment-free zone. 844-770-3776, 844-770-3776. We'll take your texts. We'll take your calls. Who do you root against? We'll continue with this. It's beneath Gary, but not beneath the rest of us topic. Next, it's Wildy and Tausch.
This is Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Hey, it's Hunter Vaughn. ESPN Madison and Zimbrick Honda are celebrating the area's best high school sports stories with the Game Changers of the Month. Follow ESPN Madison on social media to see teams making an impact in their community. Nominate your local team today at ESPNMadisonGameChangers.com.
All you have is one. One chance after an accident. One decision on who to call. One shot to get the help you need. Don't waste it on the one offer you get from your insurance company. Make the one call to Gruber Law Offices. It's the only one you'll need to make. Call us today. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Cousin Subs was founded in Milwaukee, Wisconsin in 1972 and has been a member of the Madison community for decades. This year, Cousins has expanded their footprint in the Madison area by opening new locations in Stoughton and Sun Prairie, in addition to existing locations on East Washington Avenue, Monona, and Lodi. Order your favorite subs online or via our app for delivery or pickup. Eat in or grab them to go through our drive-thru for a better sub experience. Cousin Subs, we believe in better.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at everlightsolar.com.
Hey, Drew Scott here.
And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
From color-changing alexandrite to shimmering zircon and everything in between at Chalmers Jewelers, you'll find high-quality, affordable, one-of-a-kind pieces. We source straight from the gem cutters, and we manufacture in-house from start to finish. As the manufacturer, we believe in truth in pricing. Never pay more for quality and stunning, beautiful jewelry. She's one-of-a-kind, and so should her jewelry be. While others may send your jewelry dreams to someone else to make, with us, your dreams become reality with the help of our custom jewelers, with you involved the whole way. With a staff that has over 200 years of combined experience, why buy from a place that marks up jewelry made by the thousands? When you can buy direct from Chalmers for that one-of-a-kind piece that is better quality, often for less.
Chalmers Jewelers.
And Madison.
For official rules and more information about every contest on 100.5 ESPN, visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com. That's ESPNWisconsinContest.com. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN app.
From the preps.
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros.
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
I'm going to spend this entire day talking about what a good person Gary Ellerson is.
No, don't do that.
Now I'm starting to root against you. No.
No.
You made me look bad with how nice you are.
No. No.
I thought of another person I don't like.
Who?
The guy that went from Michigan to Kansas, Hunter Dickinson.
Oh, yeah.
Right? He's a jerk.
Yeah. Don't like that guy.
Who is that guy?
He's a taunter. I will say this. I like Flauje Johnson. I don't love Angel Reese, but I don't dislike her. Again, I'm not a big taunter. She did the ring thing, and that's one of the reasons I don't love Caitlin Clark. She does the face thing. Like, just, yeah. You were in Detroit before Barry Sanders, right? He took over for you, basically. Is that if I'm remembering correctly?
Yeah, you ran me out of town.
Yeah, and so I always, and maybe this just makes me lame, I understand that, but I always really respected, and they did a really good, I think it was on Prime, maybe, Jesse? They did a good documentary about him that I really enjoyed. I don't like taunters either. Not a big taunting fan. Now, I say that, and it's a little hypocritical, because the belt with Rodgers, I was okay with that, right? And so that's a double standard.
That's no different than anything.
I was okay with that.
Well, here's the thing about the belt. So if you know the history behind it, he used to do it to the starting defense while he was a backup, and it was a tool that he used to bring all of the scout team guys together and make them more competitive and make it more fun. And he didn't do it very often, and he didn't do it in a lot of people's faces. The in-your-face type stuff is what I don't
like. How do you know Caitlin Clark didn't have a practice story about the hand?
I don't, but
thing.
I feel like it would have come out by now. Plus, she stole it from, isn't that a wrestler's move?
Yeah, it was The Rock.
Else's move, yes. Yeah.
So anyway, but Hunter Dickinson, Hey, appropriate last name. That's all I'm going to say. Don't like him. So
well,
another guy.
He was a center for
Michigan.
He had a podcast and he said some stuff about Wisconsin that wasn't particularly nice. He was kind of at the center of, well, with Juwan Howard and guard when they had that little scuffle at the Kohl Center a few years ago. Dickinson had a bunch to say about that. He was kind of like, he's not as good as Zach Edey, but he talks a bigger game than Zach Edey.
Okay, okay, there it is.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't dislike Zach Edey. I have no reason to dislike him.
He's also very dislikable.
By the way, I don't think, when you said it, I'm not a wrestling aficionado, but I did not think The Rock was the correct answer on the you can't see me face thing. I was going to say, because I wrote a story about Andy Gruber, who works in the Packers equipment staff. I wrote that for ESPN a million years ago.
Oh, shoot.
And he does that. He would do that same thing to Rodgers all the time. John Cena, you can't see me.
Not a wrestling guy. Sorry.
I don't smell what The Rock is cooking or that Jesse is getting wrestlers wrong.
Out of my lane.
Jesse, this is, I think, starting to light up the text portion of the talk and text line, and I'm getting a lot of tweets as well. What do you got?
Yeah, some of the responses are rolling in. This is the one that's been most compelling to me so far. From Jim on the South Side. I don't root against teams. That's very noble of Jim. That's
just like Gary.
That said, there are teams I won't root for. The Vikings, the Cowboys, Duke, North Carolina, and the Cubs. So then I root for their opponents. That's a heck of a spin by Jim on the South Side.
That's some hair splitting.
I don't root against these teams. I just never root for them and will root for their opponents. Come on, Jim.
Yeah, I appreciate Jim chiming in. He just wants to be a good person like Gary. I just root for their opponents.
Yeah,
that's
all that is. Isn't that like the definition of rooting against the teams? Well, I'm not rooting against the Cubs. I just really want the Pirates to beat them on a Friday in May.
And I'm watching the game expressly to root for the Pirates like Jesse does. All right, I have one other example that I want to ask Gary about. I will do that next, and we'll get into Packers talk as the show rolls on. But there is one instance of this that I always find myself, and we've talked about it before on this show, not quite understanding. I'll get into that coming up. I'll tell you this, I always root for Associated Bank. They're always there for me, and I'm there for them. It's been a great partnership on this show. They are a fantastic company, and they have fantastic customer service. Just experienced it again with my guy Ben Sorensen. I talked to him during my days off where I was trying to get my life in order. Check out AssociatedBank.com/Packers if you're a Packers fan and you want to have great customer service, but you also want the Packers perks. Packers debit MasterCard, 10% off the Packers Pro Shop in-store and online. And there might be some events coming around the corner. We're hoping. I'm hoping. So go to AssociatedBank.com/Packers to find out more. Who do you root against? Or whose opponents do you root for? We'll continue the conversation next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
LabCorp Clinical Trials is changing to a new name. Fortrea. While the name may be different, Fortrea combines decades of great experience and professionalism with new opportunities for clinical trial participation. It's more than a mission and more than a new name. Fortrea is dedicated to moving healthcare forward. To learn more about the future of healthcare and upcoming clinical trials, visit us at FortreaClinicalTrials.com. That's FortreaClinicalTrials.com.
If you're an employer looking to tap into the next strong generation of local prospective employees, then you can't miss this. 95.3 WBEV, ESPN Beaver Dam, and DailyDodge.com will be hosting the South Central Wisconsin Career Expo on April 23rd. From 9:30 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the Beaver Dam High School Fieldhouse, businesses will have the opportunity to meet with hundreds of eager juniors and seniors from area high schools, as well as adult job seekers. Employers can find more information and purchase a booth on the Career Expo page at DailyDodge.com.
What does it take to make a diamond? Extreme heat and pressure and about a billion years. but you can't wait that long. What do? You go to Goodman's Jewelers. I'm John Hayes from Goodman's Jewelers. There's a reason we are the Diamond Store of Madison. Since 1933, we provided outstanding service and selection to our customers, and that in turn has helped to establish countless great memories through the years. GoodmansJewelers.com, located at 220 State Street, truly a destination worth reaching.
Hey, hungry? And your heart is ticking for chicken? Well, take a quick turn into Quick Trip, because we got
no ordinary chicken.
Yeah, go wild with wings, next level super wings, with trusty sidekick and sauces. Or let's talk tender, quick chick tenders. Love me tenders. Love me some quick tenders. Ours are bigger, better, tastier. Or if you're feeling good old school comfort fried chicken, we got it. Hand breaded, down homier than anywhere. Quick Trip, saving your nuggets from ordinary.
One call, that's all. It's not just a slogan, but a way of life at Gruber Law Offices. If you've been injured, call our team today. We've represented tens of thousands of injured Wisconsinites for well over 30 years. Trust Wisconsin's own Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
As you're putting your spring calendar together, we'd love to have you join us Saturday, May 18th for Mark Osiki's 6th Annual Casting for Kids Fishing Tournament to support the American Family Children's Hospital, UW-Carbone Cancer Center. We're on the Madison Chain of Lakes early, then back at the Alliant Energy Center for 2:30 happy hour, dinner, and live and silent auctions with cool autographed hockey items, guided tours, and a brand new fishing boat. There's even more on our website, castingforkids.org. Help us help the kids, castingforkids.org.
It's Chevy truck season, and there's no better time to do what you do best. No better time to get the job done in a Chevy Silverado with best-in-class standard torque and a TurboMax engine with a 5-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty that outlasts both Ford and Ram. So kick off whatever your thing is season right, because it all starts with a Chevy truck.
See your Badgerland Chevy dealer today.
Based on latest competitive data, excludes other GM vehicles, whichever comes first. See dealer for limited warranty details based on Ford and Ram 5-year, 60,000-mile warranty on gasoline engines.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in 6 provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in 6 on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on Bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
Slow down on Monday.
All right, before we get to the dilemma, as Tausch would call it, that I brought up before the break, I stopped to think about this. Hunter Vaughn, lovely Hunter Vaughn.
Lovely young man. Yeah, lovely young man.
Is both a Duke fan and a Cowboys fan.
Yep.
Does he root for the Yankees in baseball, too? Like...
Why would you ask that?
Like, who roots for the Cowboys and Duke? Oh, and he's a Blackhawks fan too, isn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah, you know who roots for those people. Yeah.
He's a front runner. I mean, the Cowboys, well, I guess they're not a front runner. They haven't won a Super Bowl in 30 years.
So, can I ask a question about, I actually was thinking about this as we started talking about this before. When did Duke become hateable? Because I don't want to make anybody feel old, although I've done that a couple of times.
You have.
All I've ever known is Duke being the big bad villain of college basketball with Coach K and the national titles and Final Fours and kind of being the uppity team. So at some point, I imagine Duke must have been like a scrappy underdog story that took the world by storm. Was that, like, is that how that started, or was Duke always just for some reason, a big villain.
So they went back-to-back in 91 and 92. And I think when they won it in 91 for their first title with Coach K, which is, if my math serves me, right around when you were born?
I was born in 91, yeah.
I think that there were a lot of people rooting for them. And Gary's old enough, and I'm old enough to remember that. I was in college. But, like, they beat UNLV, which was undefeated. And then they went back-to-back, and they won, was it a regional final against Kentucky that they won with the full-court pass from Grant Hill to Leitner? I think that was the tipping point when they went back-to-back, when they stopped being the, oh, this is new, this is different, Coach K, et cetera, and then they became, you know, the Darth Vader type. Gary, do you agree with that?
Well, I think it's about Christian Leitner. I think when...
It's all his fault.
A lot of people... It is. A lot of people didn't like him, and they didn't like Duke. And that's really when it started. Yeah, well, that's really when it started.
So it was really like their collection of players from the get-go. It wasn't even necessarily like the name on the front. It was more the individuals that made up the team.
Yeah, I feel like everybody likes Grant Hill. He's a likable fellow, isn't he? It's not like he's Reggie Miller. There's another guy I root against.
Yeah, there's another one. Ding, 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 ding.
All right, so here's the one that I wanted to ask
you. There
it is.
Thank you.
Nice. I'm sure Hunter Vaughn was the lovely young man who hit that button instead of Jesse. Marquette, you and I are both Wisconsin alumni.
Yes.
I want to see Marquette do well. We've talked about this before on the show. I was disappointed. Funny enough, you know, obviously NC State goes on to beat Duke yesterday, but I was disappointed that Marquette lost to NC State. No, I love watching Tyler Kolek, Cam Jones. I love Shaka Smart, even though I'm a Wisconsin alum. But I feel like, and I've always said this, that feeling from me to them is not reciprocated from them to Wisconsin.
Oh,
and they
really?
Root against the Badgers, right?
Really?
Yeah. You don't think so?
They do?
You don't think Marquette fans root against the Badgers?
Well, they do. I don't know.
Not Gary.
Well, here's the deal. I do root for Marquette only when they're in the tournament, right? I do.
Okay.
And I root for them to do well in the tournament. You don't think it's not reciprocated the other way?
I mean, first of all, I will never paint an entire fan base with a broad brush. I am sure there are Marquette basketball fans.
Can you name names?
I know having had friends who worked at Marquette, and again, I grew up in Milwaukee. I grew up in my basement. There would be doubleheaders of me calling the games like Jesse on Bullstream TV, where there would be a doubleheader where I would be Marquette playing against Notre Dame, you know, Doc Rivers against David Rivers, no relation.
Yes.
And I had Nerf hoops at each end of my parents' basement, and I would call the game and play the game out, and Marquette would always beat, you know, DePaul, Dallas Comagies, whoever was there at the time, Tyrone Corbin. And then the Bucks would play like the Celtics or the 76ers, and I would do it again. Because I was a nerd who thought he was going to be a play-by-play announcer, kind of like Jesse. Now, I do have friends, though, that work at Marquette, who told me that you weren't allowed to carry a red binder.
Oh, my goodness.
That's what I was told. And if everybody wants to correct me on that, they're welcome to. But, look, I'm glad that we have Marquette. I've talked about this earlier last week. I am a huge Shaka Smart guy. But I have loved Marquette since I was a kid. I didn't go there, but I want to see them succeed. And when the Badgers play Marquette, I just want the game to be entertaining, kind of like tonight between LSU and Iowa. I want to be entertained. So that's me. But I'm weird, and I know that.
No, well, see, here's my backstory with Marquette. My ex-wife went to Marquette. She's the youngest of 10 in her family. And let's just say 5 went to Marquette, five of her family members, brothers and sisters, went to Wisconsin. Her mom and dad graduated from Marquette. And then they had season tickets to all Marquette's game. And then so those Marquette basketball tickets were passed down through the family. Uh-huh. So I ended up going to a lot of Marquette basketball games. So that's how I start rooting actually for Marquette, but not when they play the Badgers. So half her family root for the Badgers, Badger football, all of them, all 10 of them. They all in Badger football.
Sure.
And they root for Badger basketball. But when they play Marquette, it's a different story, right? And so that's why I'm so weird right now, probably about Marquette. And that's probably why I root for Marquette, because I used to have season tickets at the game.
Used
to.
I
no longer have them anymore. Mm-hmm. You got that, didn't you? So,
so I'm a bit weird.
Thank you very much. But although she kept her Badger tickets with me, but that's okay. It's a whole nother story.
We'll get into it. Whoa, Nelly!
Okay, if you don't want to delve into that, I understand. Yeah, but that did pique my interest. I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah. I don't know how that line got drawn, but it did. So
these are the same seats since the '90s that you were telling us about.
Yep. Those are the same seats. Yep. Those are the same seats now that I share with my ex-wife, but I do not share her Marquette tickets.
Kenny sits next to your ex-wife instead of you, though.
He used to. He used to. We have four tickets, so. So that's my love affair, I guess, with Marquette, or maybe not so much, but that's how I got indoctrinated into Marquette basketball.
Yeah, I feel
so that's
like
a bit
Homer,
weird.
Yeah, and again, you can root for whoever you want, right? That's fine.
Yeah,
I'm not judging, and there are. We have a couple of I give a couple of our teammates a hard time who are Marquette alums. They sometimes make it hard for me to continue to love Marquette because of the way they sometimes react to things that happen with Marquette. They can be a little Filipowski-ish about things. So
They can be. You know, so you asked me what team. You know who I compare Marquette to? Now you get me doing this fan base wise. You ready for this?
I'm ready.
Marquette fan base is like Michigan fan base, is like Notre Dame fan base. All of those guys are the same.
Better than you guys.
Better than you. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. I seen it.
Well, I feel like Homer told us a story, and my memory might be failing me, but I feel like Homer told us a story on the show once that he had like a sport coat, and Marquette like gave him like new outfits to wear so he wouldn't wear the red sport coat anymore. Jesse, not making that up, right?
I believe that is a story that Homer has told, yes.
Yeah. So, again, I am the farthest thing from a anti-Marquette guy. I am the absolute opposite of that, and I was bummed that they lost. But there are some times I wonder why it's not reciprocated.
Super. Well, because have you ever gone to – you've been to Marquette, Wisconsin game?
Yeah.
Here?
Mm-hmm.
At Fiserv or when it was Bradley Center, it feels like half the fan base are Wisconsin Badgers that are in there.
Mm-hmm.
They get a hold of a lot of those tickets. Mm-hmm. And when Marquette comes to Wisconsin, it's not really that way. It's all Badger fans. Obviously, we have more people than they do at the enrollment's a little bit higher, but maybe that's the case. But they don't come in to the Kohl Center and take over like we would come to Fiserv and take over.
Well, one of my favorite human beings is a Marquette alum. He was a manager during the Al McGuire era, so my good friend John Kerry makes sure that I always express my love for Marquette guys. So I want to get to a few texts and then put a bow on this, as Tausch would say, because Jesse actually read something I wrote over the weekend. So I want to get to that during the 10 o'clock hour.
Right.
We'll get to a couple of your texts. And if Kyle Filipowski's on line one, Jesse, please let me know. More of the teams or people you root against to wrap up the 9 o'clock hour next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
From the preps.
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros.
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
Listen to Madison Money Guy every Saturday morning at 7 a.m. on 100.5 ESPN and ESPNWisconsin.com.
I like to refer to inflation as the silent killer. It's an invisible risk. It's just the idea that things get more expensive over time. You're going to need milk and eggs when you're in your early 60s and when you're in your early 80s. You're going to get a loaf of bread, and it's going to be more expensive 20 years from now.
Christian Finfrock is the Madison Money Guy. Call him today at 208-1800.
You, Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Stroff.
This Badger Minute brought to you by your Badgerland Chevy dealers, proud supporters of Badger Athletics. Go to BadgerlandChevy.com. Three-star defensive lineman recruit in the class of 2025, Torin Petaway of Middleton High School, flipped his commitment from Wisconsin to rival Minnesota last week. Petaway committed to the Badgers in early March after receiving offers from Big Ten schools like Rutgers in Minnesota, but decommitted Thursday night shortly before tweeting 100% committed to coach PJ Fleck and the Minnesota Gophers. The Badgers still have plenty of time to fill their needs prior to next year's National Signing Day, which is not until February 5th of 2025.
Badger Minutes on ESPN Wisconsin are brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Schedule an appointment online today at PellaWI.com.
Haul away big deals this Thursday through Sunday at Fleet Farm's Truckload Savings Event. Like 40-pound bags of black oil sunflower seed on sale for $14.99. Save on a Blackstone 28-inch griddle with cover and accessories, just $249.99. Pick up 4 bags of garden soil on sale for $10. And save on 40 pounds of Morton water softening pellets for only $5.79. Stock up on everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner, and we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
When you're in the right place at the right time, things get done. The important things, like knowing what you need and how it all works. Talking truck. Fixing it right the first time. At Zimbrick Chevrolet, our people get it done right and now. That's how you know you're in the right place at the right time. And you'll never overpay at Zimbrick Chevrolet.
Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company is a Madison original, brewing award-winning craft beers for nearly 30 years. Whether you're a fan of Pilsners, IPAs, Stouts, or Sours, the Dane's team of brewers always have something new on tap. Or if you're in the mood for a classic, enjoy the German Pilsner or Crop Circle Wheat. For a full tap list, head to one of their locations in Fitchburg, Hilldale, Downtown, or East Madison, or visit GreatDanePub.com. Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's original brew pub since 1994.
Wilde and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
Putting a bow on our confirmation that we're not very nice people, that we root against other teams. Jesse, I just got a tweet from my buddy Steve in the Twin Cities. He agreed with my Duke take and then added, although my passionate distaste for all things Duke has cooled a bit since Coach K retired, Shire is just harder to hate. I would agree with that.
Yeah.
I used to like Coach K. he became a little sanctimonious for me, for my liking, and then came the meddling with the officials when the Badgers had a chance to win a national title, and that was kind of it for me with Coach K.
Coaches, it's very easy to dislike, and when they move on, or even specific player. Like, I remember with the Cubs in the early 2000s when they had, like, Derek Lee, Aramis Ramirez, Moises Alou, that whole squad. Like, there were some really dislikable Cubs players growing up at that point that I loved rooting against them. And then when they moved on, they weren't as hateable. But then a new crop comes in, and you learn to hate them because they beat the Brewers in big moments, or you learn their personalities. And this circle of life continues.
You know what I wonder? I wonder how Packer fans are perceived outside of the state of Wisconsin. I wonder.
It's a great question.
What do you think? Because we win a lot. I mean, you know, are we considered a little snooty, a little uppity, a little holier than thou, Packer fans?
Ooh, holier than thou. Another nice line. I think there are probably football fans who view Packers fans with the same, you guys think you're better than us, as baseball fans view Cardinals fans.
Okay.
I don't know, but here's the thing. It's countless the number of times I've seen fans from visiting teams talk about how gracious and friendly Packers fans were to them when they came to Lambeau Field, right?
Countless, yes. All the time.
So do you think that there's again, not every fan base can be painted with no fan base can be painted with a broad brush. But I would think that there are probably Bears fans, and it's probably fueled by jealousy more than anything else, who think Packers fans are douchey. Right?
Yeah.
But I don't know if they actually are, and if that's more of a perception problem, because I think there are certainly fans that are part of the Packers fan base that I can see rubbing other teams' fans the wrong way. Right? We all have them in our friendship groups.
Yes.
If I may paint with a broad brush for a moment, I do think there's kind of two, like, different stages of Packers fans. I think there's the older Packers fans who are viewed more nationally, I think, by people outside of Wisconsin or not close to the I think the older Packers fans are viewed as the friendly, you have a beer, have a brat, come tailgate, like, you know, thinking about the fans who have been passionate since the Ice Bowl. And then there's the younger fans like me, who are viewed as the, like, arrogant, entitled, all they know is winning, flaunting, flexing the division titles on the Bears and the Vikings. And
good point.
I think there's kind of a age difference in how Packers fans may be viewed, because now, you know, my generation is getting older and there's more of us, and so I think that could have something to do with that
my
trash
generation.
Talk. Yeah, I mean, that's just what we're comparing the two. I mean, that's kind of where we're at.
No, I like it. You're right.
I would agree with that. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if they're as strongly disliked as other fan bases, but I'm guessing that they are. There are those that think they know Packers fans. I would say that if I were to describe Packers fans, when they come to your town and take over your stadium, when the Packers are going and really playing good football and winning games on the road, and the Go Pack Go chant starts and the big sombrero and elsewhere, I feel like they are looked at more as like fun-loving heavy drinkers who love their team.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Right?
Yep.
Fun-loving heavy drinkers. Okay.
All right. We will we'll get to some real football. I want to thank Jesse beforehand for reading an actual story that I wrote, because that doesn't happen very often on this program. We'll talk about that and how the Packers are different offensively than they were a year ago at this time, and something that Matt LaFleur said at the NFL meetings last week that really perked my ears up. We'll talk about that to kick off the 10 o'clock hour with Gary Ellerson as our cousin sub of the day. Cousin subs, we believe in better. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
This is former Wisconsin linebacker Chris Orr. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN, WTLX, Monona, Madison, a Good Karma Brands radio station on Wisconsin.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kia of Madison Sports Center.
Good morning, Madison. I'm Jesse Nelson. Sports Center brought to you by Goodman's Jewelers, the diamond store of Madison for generations. Check them out, 220 State Street and online at goodmansjewelers.com. The Milwaukee Brewers off to a hot start to begin the 2024 Major League Baseball season, sweeping the New York Mets over the weekend at Citi Field, including a 4-1 win on Sunday afternoon. The crew 3-0 for the first time since 2018, off today as they return home to AmFam Field for the home opener tomorrow afternoon, 3:10 first pitch. The Milwaukee Brewers hosting the Minnesota Twins. Listen to that game on our sister station, 620. WTMJ. Meanwhile, college basketball. Marquette falls in the Sweet 16 to North Carolina State. They ended up making the Final Four. Nice for them over the weekend. So who's left playing college basketball? How about Wisconsin women's basketball? The Badgers in action in the Great Eight of the women's NIT tonight, hosting St. Louis University at the Kohl Center. Tip time is set for 7 o'clock. Plenty of reactions to Marquette's loss over the weekend and the rest of the NCAA tournament. Continuing with Gary Ellerson and his cousin sub of the day for Tausch, along with Jason, next on Wilde and Tausch.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
Clock out of Wilde and Tausch.
What was that?
I don't know. That was me multitasking, trying to tweet out people to listen again. Is Twitter dying? Is it significantly less popular? I know Tausch doesn't like it when I talk about his guy Elon, but
yeah,
engagement
so.
Level is not the same as it used to be.
You don't think
me,
so?
Anyway. Maybe it's because I don't use it as much and I've been dropped from the algorithm. But if you get the Wisconsin State Journal or you visit Madison.com, over the weekend there was a piece written by a mediocre journalist who covers the Packers about how different things are for Matt LaFleur and the offensive coaches this offseason as opposed to this time last offseason. For those who have forgotten, I think Aaron Rodgers had emerged from his darkness retreat at this point. And we are about 23 days out from the anniversary, the one-year anniversary of him being traded to the Jets. So this was around the time that we were having the leverage debate. Who has more leverage?
Yeah.
Right? That was fun. I remember those days.
The good old days.
But not only that, so we knew that the Packers were trading Rodgers or were working to trade Rodgers. So we knew Jordan Love was going to be the starting quarterback. But we had no real idea who the hell he was going to be throwing the football to. Alan Lazard had signed with the Jets in anticipation of Aaron Rodgers joining them. Randall Cobb was a free agent. Mercedes Lewis had not been re-signed. He ended up with the Bears. And so Matt LaFleur and Adam Stenovich and the offensive coaches were trying to figure out what the hell's going on out here on offense. And that's something Matt LaFleur talked about at the NFL meetings last week. Here he is via Packers.com.
Yeah, we were talking about this as an offensive staff the other day with Adam Stenovich before the draft last year. We didn't even know who was going to be on our team. So it's hard to plan and really put together an offense when you have no idea, when you don't know who your tight ends are necessarily going to be. You didn't really know who your other wideouts were going to be. So there were some holes, and to have a lot less and have everything kind of in place, it allows you to plan a little bit better, I think, and be very intentional with your offseason. So I do think we'll have a better plan in place when the guys come back in terms of where we want to take our offense.
So, Gary, the great American orator Mark Tauscher would say no blank blank, that you're in a better position. But explain to me just how difficult that must have been for those coaches last year to be putting together their off-season program, to be thinking about, all right, we're going to go from a quarterback who changed plays, you know, the Stenovich quote from during the season where they would come off the field in the past with Rodgers at quarterback and him. One of the things that they wanted to do was get over to Rodgers to ask him what exactly he'd run at the end of a series because they didn't know. Going from him to Jordan Love, who was going to follow the game plan and do what's called. How difficult must that have been, and how different will it be for these coaches this year?
Or the signal comes to Cobby and everybody's looking at each other. Do you know what signal that he just gave to Cobby? No, but Cobby does.
Right. Right.
No one else does, but Cobby. That's all that matters. I will say this, Jason. I think we talked a little bit about this last week with the whole process of Matt LaFleur coming out and talking about Aaron Jones, that he may or may not have known that trade went down or whatever. I think in this case, this is what helps, though, Matt LaFleur, in that he doesn't have to worry about whether Rodgers was going to be coming back or not. You just go get the football players and you go coach them up and get that figured out. I'll take care of Aaron Rodgers. In that case, I think it works for the Green Bay Packers the way they do business when they come to crossroads like this. And now if you fast forward to this offseason, right now you're still trying to figure out, or maybe you do know already, the strong suits of the receivers that you have in place. Now you have a base of, you know what your receivers do well. You know what your tight ends, Kraft, you know what they like to do, mm-hmm. or what they do well. I think you have a better handle on the talent that you have, and now you can begin to have a game plan on how to attack certain defenses by knowing what your receivers do well in the game plan that you put out there. Because it feels like to me you saw Matt LaFleur this year game plan a lot and scheme a lot of guys open due to what their strong suits are within this offense. And we know what Jalen Reed, we know what he brings to the table. I mean, he's a guy I feel like can do a little bit of everything. I think he can go on the outside. He can come to the inside. I can think he can play a little bit of running back. I think he can do all those things. And for me, I think the offense should be built off of that one guy, if you know what I mean, to set other plays up.
So, all right, so a year ago, you knew you had Watson, and you knew you had Dobbs, and you knew you had Samori Toure, right? Although you didn't really know what Toure was, you had an okay idea of what Dobbs was, and you saw the big plays from Christian Watson. But again, Christian Watson was kind of compacted into like a three-game stretch where he was great. Mm-hmm. So you didn't really know. And quite frankly, I'm not sure you still know entirely what he's capable of because of all the issues he had last season. But then you add Luke Musgrave, Tucker Kraft, mm-hmm. Jaden mm-hmm. Reed, mm-hmm. Dontavian Wicks. Don't forget that they also added Malik Heath as an undrafted free mm-hmm. agent at wide receiver. He played a ton of snaps.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So
Bo Melton.
Bo Melton, who
came out of nowhere.
was added to the practice squad late in the 2022 season. I don't think anybody saw coming what he did at the end of the year. Now he's part of that mix. Like, it's amazing to me that we went, and this is why I thought the story is worth writing, that we went from all this uncertainty to now it's like an embarrassment of riches that they have. Mm-hmm. And so to flip it to the other direction, Gary, what exactly can, like it's almost like Matt LaFleur has the absolute opposite problem. He went from mm-hmm. not knowing what he had to work with to now, how do I figure out a way for all these guys to be involved in the offense? Because they all deserve opportunities, right?
Right. Well, how to make it fit? How do right. you make it work? How do you play one guy off of another? And I think that is going to be his problem within this offense. It was a great problem to have. Like you talked about Christian Watson. What is his strong suit? What does he do well? Well, we know he can take the top off the defense, right? Mm-hmm. But when he is good or when he is great, he can be one of the best receivers in the NFL. We've seen it. So how do you implement him back into this offense with all the other guys that he has? I mean, you may not have to ask Christian Watson to go across the middle because you have a lot of other guys that can do that. Maybe Watson gets lost in the shuffle, and that next thing you know, he's caught in four passes for 125 yards, and they all are downfield because I've been hitting all these other guys underneath. I've been giving you misdirections. I got Jacobs coming out of the backfield. He's doing things. So I think you're right. It is this year, it's about Matt LaFleur now game planning, designing situation for these guys to get open, encompassing with what is their strong suit? What do they do best?
I mean, literally the one guy now that you don't know enough about based on how he will fit what you do is the running back.
Correct.
Like, you've changed out Aaron Jones, who, again, if we're being honest, he did miss a ton of time last year. So it's not like they didn't have to figure out ways to function without him. But Josh Jacobs is a different cat. And he's going to have different strengths. So you go from having this challenge of figuring out, we don't even know who's going to be on our team, to now, all right, how do we integrate Josh Jacobs and his style? I would much rather have the current problem than last year's problem. And, oh, by the way, you also know that your young quarterback, who was going to be a starter for the first time and whose body of work going into the offseason program a year ago was a not very good appearance in his only start against Kansas City and 10 outstanding snaps against Philly in a game that you lost. Mm-hmm. That was basically the feel that you had for Jordan Love. Now you know what routes he throws well. You know what he does well on the move. You have seen during the second half of the season everything that he is good at, in addition to everything that all these other guys are good at. I'll be curious how, like, Gary, I don't know from your experience watching LaFleur and watching his play calling, I thought in the second half of last season, he and Love were in total sync. Like, they seemed to really hit their rhythm. I'm curious, when you watch his design, when you're up there in the press box with me and you're looking down and watching things unfold from the bird's eye view, do you think he's creative? Because if he is, then all kinds of possibilities open up now for him to be even more creative, right?
I really do think he is. I think the design of his plays are designed for one person in that he knows which guy is going to be open according to what defensive look that they get. Unlike with Aaron Rodgers, I felt like Aaron was just looking for one guy, no matter what the route was, I'm throwing it to Davante Adams. In this offense, the design is, okay, if you get this defense, Watson's going to be open. If you get this defense, same play, Romeo Doubs is going to be open. They already know who's going to be open by the coverage that they're going to get. And all I need for you to do is just throw it to the open guy. Don't make it up. You don't have to be creative. Just get it to the open guy, and we don't have to worry about getting all these other guys, you know, catches that they need or having a favorite target. I think to me, those guys in the locker room and in the receiving room, all those guys got to be on the same page as well, is that I don't need 100 targets. I don't need to catch over 100 balls. I still can continue to be a team player. I don't know how long that's going to last in that receiving room, because at some point, one of those guys is going to get outside the box and say, I need more catches, because you can make more money, obviously. Mm-hmm. But at this point right now, I feel like they're young enough where they're all kind of playing together in concert with one another and in design of this offense. They see it can work. They know it can work. And they're just running the offense. I think Matt LaFleur, to me, when you go back to this, Jason, they had to have known in the beginning that, okay, you got Aaron Rodgers. He's only be here for 2-3 years. Fine, whatever it is. Can you lead us into the next process or the next phase of Packer history with another quarterback? I think they had to have known, they had to have that vision in mind when they hired him, if he can do that. If you look at Matt LaFleur's record when he was with the Titans, it wasn't the greatest. I was surprised at that hire. I mean, he didn't actually he wasn't doing well there. I mean, their offense
Vrabel
wasn't
was ready
good.
To fire him. Yep, Vrabel was going to fire him. Yep, you're right. And he held off. And look, now Vrabel's the one who's out of a job. This was also why I never thought Mike Vrabel was going to be the Packers' defensive coordinator. He'll be spending more time with the Badgers instead, visiting his old buddy Luke Fickell. But, yeah, and look, that's proof, too, that just because – like, Mike McCarthy coordinated the worst offense in the NFL in 2005, right?
Mm-hmm.
49ers had the worst-ranked offense. Seemed to do okay once he had Aaron Rodgers. And
correct.
Seemed to do okay, won a Super Bowl. So – you know, the idea that Matt LaFleur was bad in Tennessee, maybe the situation was bad. But the bottom line is, turns out he knows what he's doing. And when he's got players, but I want to get, you said something that really perked my ears about Rodgers and Devontae and the idea of what might be lurking around the corner. Not necessarily this year, but at some point in the future. We'll talk about that coming up next. Gary Ellerson is our cousin sub of the day. I was at Fleet Farm yesterday, or Saturday, and I got my bonus bucks. I got my Fleet bucks, spent $10 of free money that they gave me in my rewards program. And Fleet Farms is also now hiring. It's the perfect time for you to join a team where you can learn every day, have fun, and be yourself. Plus, you'll get that 20% off team member discount for you and your family. The amount of time I spend there, maybe I can start picking up shifts the way Hunter Vaughn, that lovely young man, picks up shifts on Wildy and Tash. You can apply today at careers.fleetfarm.com. Fleet Farm has everything you need to stay dry and comfortable this spring as well. So shop their wide selection of spring clothing for everyone in the family. Check out spring jackets, T-shirts, denim, and rain boots from top brands. Find it all at your local store or online at fleetfarm.com. I'm going to ask Gary about when could things change for this offense, because right now, again, good problems to have. Maybe they have a different good problem to have a year from now. We'll talk about that next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
This is Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Big trailers and big opportunity. Since 1962, Stoughton Trailers has been a family-owned and operated business. With competitive wages and excellent benefits, plus growth and advancement opportunities, Stoughton Trailers is an exciting place to grow your career. Join the collaboration, innovation, and dynamic team atmosphere at Stoughton Trailers. With positions now open in production, operations, finance, sales, engineering, supply chain, and more. Go to stojobs.com to apply today. Stoughton Trailers, big trailers, big opportunity.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. What's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers, the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
From the biggest plays on the court
to the comments made in the locker room after. An in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in 6 provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in 6 on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
Hey, it's Hunter Vaughn. ESPN Madison and Zimbrick Honda are celebrating the area's best high school sports stories with the Game Changers of the Month. Follow ESPN Madison on social media to see teams making an impact in their community. Nominate your local team today at ESPNMadisonGameChangers.com.
Good Karma Brands is proud to be an equal opportunity employer. Our policy is to provide equal opportunity employment, development, and advancement to all current and potential teammates. If you are an organization that maintains a job bank, provides employment information, or gives job referrals, you may request to be placed on the station's mailing list for future career opportunities. To learn more about careers at Good Karma Brands, please email careers@goodkarmabrands.com.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you outdoors because we get you. Whether you're ready to work in the yard, tackle a project, or enjoy family time, we get you the right products at the right prices. Right now, rewards members get a free $10 Blaine's gift card with a $100 purchase of Estate Fertilizer, 35-pound bags of Blaine's brand Golden Harvest Bird Food, $12.99, and get a free $15 Blaine's gift card when you buy select bags of Hill's Science Diet dog or cat food. We get you outdoors because we get you at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner, and we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
Hey, it's Ben Brust, and join me for a look back on one of the most memorable basketball seasons in Badger history. A banner year, the story of the 2014 Wisconsin Final Four team, featuring great conversations with Bo Ryan, Frank Kaminsky, Barstool Big Cat, Ian Eagle, and more.
Wisconsin is headed to the Final Four.
Starting April 1st, find it on ESPN Madison's YouTube channel, live on 100.5 ESPN, and wherever you get your podcasts.
Join the Madison Money Guy, Christian Finfrock, for retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Get the information you need as you plan for retirement. That's retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Investment advisory services offer the retirement income strategies and SEC registered investment advisor.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
Gary Ellerson is our cousin sub of the day. Cousin subs, we believe in better. All right, speaking of good problems to have, which is, by the way, one of my cliches that I don't really like, because a good problem to have inherently is still a problem, and problems aren't good. So if you do have that problem, yeah, it's great. But it still means you got to figure it out and fix it and find ways to manage it. And here's the problem they don't currently have in Green Bay that I'm curious when they will. Because I've made my pick. I'm a Dontavian Wicks guy. Okay. That doesn't mean that I'm not a Jaden Reed guy. Doesn't mean I'm not a Romeo Doubs guy. I've drawn these parallels before. I think Reed is Cobb. I think Dobbs is James Jones, and I think Dontavian Wicks is Devontae Adams, potentially.
Ooh.
Now, they all have a – they all
oh,
– all
boy.
Three of those guys.
Ooh.
Yeah, this is why LaFleur got pissed at Buck and Aikman Ooh. For taking him saying the same thing I just did and then mentioning it on the telecast on Monday Night Football. But, Gary – if let's just say, and they all have a lot more to prove, just like Jordan Love has a lot more to prove before we're saying he's the next Hall of Fame quarterback. But they all have qualities similar to those players. Let's say Dontayvion Wicks does turn out to be Devontae-esque, maybe not as good, but similar, to the point where he's your one, right? He can run all the routes. He can take the top off the defense. He can go across the middle and take hits. He can make plays on the sideline. At what point does that become a good problem to have? Because you said something that I thought was really interesting, which is that Rodgers got to a point, and I think this is true, and maybe this is somewhere where Goody deserves a small amount of criticism, not just for trading away Devontae Adams, although it's worked out well since, at least this past season it did. But the fact that they didn't have, like, T. Higgins to Ja'Marr Chase. The Packers didn't have, like, that number two where you were like, God, that number two would be a number one on some other teams. Because when I think back to that Sports Illustrated cover with Rodgers sitting on his helmet and he's surrounded by Finley and Cobb and Driver and Jones and Nelson, right?
That was a lot.
Yeah, and Rodgers was never, not at that point, even with as good as Jordy was becoming, Jennings was in that picture too, and Jennings was the one at the time. But they always had a two who was ready to become the one, right? Driver replaced by Jennings. Jennings replaced by Nelson. Nelson replaced by Adams. But they got to a point, and I would agree with you, in 21 and 22, where it was Adams and Adams and Adams.
No
and
matter
Adams,
what.
Right?
No matter what. Yes, no
and
matter
Rodgers
what.
And Rodgers wasn't the type to just throw to one guy until he was. So do you see that as a potential situation for this group? Because right now, it's like Rodgers in 11 when he won his first MVP. He's got all kinds of guys to throw to, and Rodgers was not only throwing to one guy back in 11. He just wasn't.
Well, here's my take on that. I think, to me, Christian Watson has the most talent out of all those receivers. I think he has the biggest upside. He is, but he's got to stay healthy. That's the big thing with him. Can you get him to play 16 games, 15 games, right?
Right.
I don't think he's going to play 17, but can you get him to at least 15 games? To me, he has, like, most certainly the most upside. He can tilt to field. I mean, he is almost JerMichael Finley-ish type talent where you can just feel the momentum swing when he makes the catches that he can make. And it feels like those guys in the locker room understand that as well, but he just can't stay healthy. I think maybe Wicks may be my second guy, and then Reed may be my third guy. But I would only say this, and I have to see a little bit more of it. I also think that Reed may be the glue that holds it all together in order for Wicks to be Wicks. Where I got Reed doing all this other stuff, underneath stuff, motion guy, and there is Wicks coming in motion again and getting into the middle and running all those little choice routes in the middle, and then I can also get him outside. I would say probably as a route runner, Wicks most certainly is the most versatile out of all those guys, can run everything on the route tree. But I think the offense with the players that they have sets up these other guys to have successful season. Do you kind of understand what I'm saying, how this thing
I do.
Comes together?
I understand it. I understand it. And look, I don't want this to be – because I get a lot of grief about this, you know, when I say I like Jordan Love. I really like Jaden Reed. I think he's more – I think he's got more in his toolbox than one of my favorite players that I ever covered in Randall Cobb. Like,
he
people
does.
Forget,
Agreed.
But people forget that Randall Cobb in 2014, the year that both he and Jordy went over 90 catches and both went over, you know, whatever it was, 1,200 yards. They both were Pro Bowlers. Like, Cobb could do more than just run out of the slot or line up in the backfield on occasion. He could run routes down the sideline and beat guys down the field. Like, I always felt like he got kind of pigeonholed as, oh, he's a slot guy, which he wasn't at the peak of his powers. Maybe at the end of his time in Green Bay, he was more of just a slot guy, but not in his best years, right? And so I love what Jaden Reed gives. He is a Swiss Army knife, or if you love the naked gun, a Swiss Army shoe. But he's also he's got some bulk to him. Like, he's bigger, a little – he's more of a running back than Cobb was. Yes. Like, he's built like a running back more so. Fair?
Fair. Bigger, so, I think he's bigger. You wouldn't know the numbers, but it feels like to me he's bigger, faster, and stronger than Cobb.
Yeah, and capable of all kinds of things that Cobb was in his heyday, but also a little bit more, right? They didn't run a lot of jet sweeps, for example, back during that time. He's the guy that I think can not only make a guy miss, he can get the corner, and then he can run a guy over. Like, I think that – so I think your line about him being the glue and the guy that his versatility frees up other guys is absolutely true. I don't think there's any doubt about that. I guess my question would be, when I look at their group, who is the guy that looks the most like a one in terms of his ability to do everything and isn't quite the same size as Jaden Reed? And that's why I pick Wicks.
Well, you're at practice a lot. When I watch Watson, he's big. He's a big dude. I mean, he is stacked, man. He's just got to stay healthy. I mean, you've seen bits and pieces of him high pointing the ball. I mean, you've seen like catches that he can make, and you're just asking yourself, can he do it for at least 15 games? He has, to me, the most raw talent on this team. When you're talking about combination of size, speed, and strength, is absolutely incredible.
Well, let's talk
more
about
him beside him. When you walk beside this guy, you can just feel his presence. He's a big dude.
And there's no denying his talent. There is certainly questioning his durability. Let's talk more about him, because you have been on his bandwagon for quite a while, even when others were jumping off and pulling their hamstrings as they did it. So we'll talk more about Christian Watson as we roll on with Gary Ellerson as our cousin sub of the day for Tausch. Cousin subs, we believe in better. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit CelebrationsEntertainment.com. That's CelebrationsEntertainment.com.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Greg Scalzo here for Buck and Honey's. Congratulations to the perennial Best of Madison Award winner by the folks at Madison Magazine. Meet me at Buck and Honey's to celebrate Wisconsin hospitality. Whether you're enjoying the view on the Yahara River in Monona, exploring Wanakee, visiting the OG in Sun Prairie, or checking out the new location in Mount Horeb, you can enjoy the Buck and Honey's experience in a neighborhood near you. Serving lunch and dinner 7 days a week with brunch every Saturday and Sunday. I'll see you at Buck and Honey's.
Life's better with American Family Insurance, because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit MFM.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
Ben Bruss here to tell you about Zimbrick European. They're Mercedes, Audi, Porsche, and certified pre-owned. But the best part is, I've been working with them since 2018, and the evolution has been a two-door, a four-door, and now it's time for an SUV. My life has changed, and it's changed with Zimbrick European. Being a dad has made it really important to have the comfort and the safety that the SUV will bring me. Again, Zimbrick European off the Beltline at Rimrock Road. Of course, I found the sexiest car on the lot. Check them out.
Are you in need of expert exterior renovations? Look no further than Ridgetop Exteriors. For over 22 years, we've been the trusted name in roofing, siding, windows, doors, and gutter replacements. With a track record of excellence on our Google reviews, we take pride in transforming houses into dream homes. Visit us today at RidgetopExteriors.com for a free consultation. That's RidgetopExteriors.com. Ridgetop Exteriors, your trusted local affordable partners.
Good Karma Brands is proud to be an equal opportunity employer. Our policy is to provide equal opportunity employment, development, and advancement to all current and potential teammates. If you are an organization that maintains a job bank, provides employment information, or gives job referrals, you may request to be placed on the station's mailing list for future career opportunities. To learn more about careers at Good Karma Brands, please email careers@goodkarmabrands.com.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
With tears in my eyes, the love in my soul.
Gary, were you teammates? Did you cross over with Christian Watson's dad during your Packers time, or were you not in the same window?
No, I was not in the same window.
Because he may be the only one who's more supportive of Christian Watson than you are.
Well, you are. You're very supportive.
I am. I do like him as a player and as a dude. He won our Tom Mulhern Award this year. Shared it with Aaron Jones. He's a hard guy not to like.
Is there not a requirement for amount of games you have to play to win that award?
No. Here's one of the reasons why he won it, frankly, is because even when he was hurt, he still talked.
Yeah.
Which, exactly. there ain't a lot of guys that do that. Devondre Campbell. But there's no doubting that he has immense talent. Like, when he went on that 3-4-game burner 2 years ago in 2022 as a rookie, like, the stat was he did something that only Randy Moss had done before.
Yeah.
And if your name is mentioned in the same sentence as Randy Moss, you have some game.
Wow.
That is not a fluke. But my question for you, Gary, as his I'm behind you. It's his dad, then there's you, then there's me. Is we were talking about the diversified route tree that Wicks can run, and my question for you is, have you seen enough from Watson in his two kind of injury-plagued NFL seasons to feel confident that he has more than just... Because what I don't want him to be is Corey Bradford MVS, right?
I've seen that.
Because He's better than that, I think.
Yes.
Have you seen enough to believe that he can do more than just take the top off the defense?
I think you saw him do a lot of that this year, run intermediate routes. I thought we saw him come across the middle. We saw Matt LaFleur use him in a lot of ways within his offense, like he used Jaden Reed in that. They break him in motion, of course, jet sweeps and all that stuff, but still they ran little short routes off of that to stack on top of otherwise. So I think invariably that's that offense, right? That offense really is about stacking routes, making routes look like other routes, making run plays look like routes and all those types of things. So I think, yes, he needs to improve. I would agree with you. I think the best route runner out of all of these guys is probably Wicks, no doubt about it. He can run it all. I think, but the most talent, and I think this guy can do that, is still run the route tree and get better. Once he masters all that, he should be the best player. Now, it's up to Matt LaFleur and those guys to develop that in him, not pigeonhole him into being a Corey Bradford. But we saw that out of him last year, where I think if you looked at Jordan Love, all the interceptions that he threw, they're basically going to Christian Watson.
Yes.
Right? They were force feeding him the ball a lot. Uh-huh. And he just couldn't come up with the catches. I think they're trying to develop him that way where he can run the route tree. I don't disagree with you. The best route runner is Wicks. But I think when you look at Reed, I think he can run everything on the route tree. And you're right. They've got a lot of players right there that can surprise you. Bo Melton came out of nowhere last year. Malik Heath. They've got a lot of guys that can do different things. But to me, your top three guys, in any order how you want to do it, is Watson, Wicks, and Reed. And I think, but all three of those guys are all different. And then out of that, what do you do with Tucker Kraft? What do you do with Musgrave out of all that as well? It's just an interesting thing to have. And you know they're going to miss Josiah DeGuara because he's the guy that really, outside of Reed, that holds this thing together.
We're going to talk about this. I want to ask you about Watson and his hamstrings in the next segment. So, for those that are unfamiliar with your affinity for now Jacksonville Jaguars,
you're going to miss him.
Fullback / tight end. Yeah, no.
Swiss Army knife.
There is a.
If you're talking about one. He's a Swiss Army knife.
Josiah DeJaguar.
Yeah. Who's going to take his place?
Not to be confused with Marcus Damask. So where does this – because this goes back to when Gary and I and Greg Matzik were doing our pregame show before Packers games during the 2022 season. That was when I learned – of your love for Josiah DeGuara. Was it the beard? Did you have an interaction with him? What was it? Because there, if we're being honest, there were not a lot of Josiah DeGuara carrying the banner for old Josiah.
What?
But you were. What is the genesis of that?
I don't know. You got to root for an underdog. He was the underdog guy. But he could do everything, though, on the field and didn't get a lot of credit for him. Go ask your buddy Rob Domowski. There's nobody right now that can do what he did in this offense. They're going to miss him. What fullback do they have right now that can
do it? Henry Pearson.
Who the hell is Henry Pearson? Who is he?
He was on the practice squad. He played in a few games late in the year. Henry Pearson is your new Josiah DeGuara.
There aren't many players that in a game in like November or December can make a catch, and you're like, wait a minute, who is that? And that happened last year. He caught, I don't know if it was, I forgot what game, Pittsburgh maybe? It's like, wait a minute, who's 40 or whatever number he was? Yeah.
81.
But they have. 81. Yeah, but they have so... They have so many tight ends right now. What's the other guy? Is it Ben Simmons?
Ben Simmons,
number one pick.
Yeah, him, not him. But they got the Ben Simmons, and then who's it? Tyler Davis?
Tyler Davis, although Tausch called him Smitty because he thought his last name was Smith, which it wasn't.
Tyler Smith?
T- Tyler Davis.
Tyler Davis.
Don't influence you. No. You think he's Smitty too. So no, Tyler Davis coming off the ACL.
No, I can see Tosh going, oh, Smitty there.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's exactly what happened. Do you know in four NFL seasons, 50 career games, 10 career starts, do you know how many passes old Josiah DeGuara caught for the Green Bay Packers in four seasons as a third-round pick out of Cincinnati? If I set the more or less prize picks projection at 52.5, would you take more or less over four seasons?
Well, my number was 50. Right on, but was my number. So less.
In 50 games, Josiah DeGuara was targeted 58 times.
Oh.
He caught 47 passes in four seasons.
You know, he could have caught more balls if he was more friendly with Aaron Rodgers.
Well, in fairness to him, he tore his ACL his rookie year.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
They had big plans for him. So he only had one reception as a rookie. 25 catches in 2021, helping Aaron Rodgers to the second of his two consecutive four overall MVPs. Big piece of that. 13 catches in 2022 when he played in all 17 games. And 8 catches for 65 yards last season for Josiah DeGuara.
I think Gary likes the idea of Josiah DeGuara. I don't think Gary actually likes Josiah DeGuara.
He sees
DeGuara.
Him as a Kyle Juszczyk, except not nearly as good.
Not nearly as good. If we were using him that way, he would be that good, though.
I have nothing against him. He is not Devondre Campbell to me. I think he deserves the benefit of the doubt because my recollection from the 2020 season was that they were planning on having him be a crucial component to their offense.
Yeah.
Then he tore his ACL in October against the Falcons, I think. I remember sitting in the press box with my mask on. It was the middle of COVID, and the stadium was empty, and he tore his ACL against Atlanta. And I would have. That's one of those injuries where he didn't have the Bakhtiari issues, but I think the window kind of closed on him, and he was, you know, he started to kind of round into form in 21 during the second half of the season, but by then Rodgers had fallen in love with Mercedes Lewis even deeper. They started to kind of do some different things with Adams, and Josiah DeGuara was kind of a forgotten guy. So I'm eager to see what he does at Jacksonville. So I'm definitely not rooting against him from earlier in the show.
Jason, real quick, I know we got to get a break, but answer this when you come back. If you are a defensive coordinator and you're going on up against the Packers this year, you got this whole offseason to take a look at this offensive system that the Packers put in place, who do you stop?
Well, it just got a lot easier now that Josiah DeGuara plays for the Jaguars. We'll answer that question with Gary Ellerson, our cousin sub of the day. Cousin subs, we believe in better. It's Wilde and Tausch.
From the preps.
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes it a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros.
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. Well, what's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers, the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
You, rah, rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Stroph.
This Badger Minute brought to you by Stoughton Trailers. Big trailers and big opportunity at Stoughton Trailers. Learn more about why a career at Stoughton Trailers might be for you. Go to stojobs.com. Three-star defensive lineman recruit in the class of 2025, Torin Pettaway of Middleton High School, flipped his commitment from Wisconsin to rival Minnesota last week. Pettaway committed to the Badgers in early March after receiving offers from Big Ten schools like Rutgers and Minnesota, but decommitted Thursday night shortly before tweeting 100% committed to coach PJ Fleck and the Minnesota Gophers. The Badgers still have plenty of time to fill their needs prior to next year's National Signing Day, which is not until February 5th of 2025.
Badger Minutes on ESPN Wisconsin are brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Schedule an appointment online today at PellaWI.com.
Join the Madison Money Guy, Christian Finfrock, for retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Get the information you need as you plan for retirement. That's retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Investment advisory services offer the retirement income strategies and SEC-registered investment advisor.
There's a good chance if you watch sports, you're getting served information about hormone optimization. What does that even mean? Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health can tell you exactly what hormone optimization means. He will take your blood work and let you know if it's right for you. If you're feeling sluggish, not losing weight like you used to, you're not gaining muscle like you used to, or you just don't feel like yourself in most aspects of your life, go see Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health. In fact, sign up for the 6-week experience so you can see everything that Carbon World Health has to offer, including hormone optimization. Learn more at carbonworldhealth.com.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
We all share the same roads, but when an accident happens, we don't always share the same consequences. Big trucks can cause big damage. Injuries can be severe and may require a lifetime of care and compensation. Call Gruber Law Offices today. We can help you from the safety and comfort of your own home. Our virtual sign-up process is quick and easy. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
For official rules and more information about every contest on 100.5 ESPN, visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com. That's ESPNWisconsinContest.com. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN app.
Hey, it's Michelle Smallman, and coming up Tuesday, we've got a huge matchup tonight between LSU and Iowa. Which team will advance to the Final Four? Full reaction tomorrow morning on Unsportsmanlike, 6 a.m. Eastern on ESPN Radio, the ESPN app, and ESPN2. But I won't cry for yesterday. There's a thorn in every wound. Somehow I have to fight. And as I try to make my way to the ordinary world, I will learn to survive.
Gary Ellis. And our cousin sub of the day. All good things must come to an end. And he will be departing us at the top of the hour. But thank you for your service. I can't even imagine
anytime.
How difficult Thursday and Friday were for you.
Anytime.
You asked me a question. Sorry, Jesse.
Yeah.
You asked me a question earlier. And of course, I was joking when I say, it's easier now that Josiah DeGuara is not on the roster. But the whole idea is it's really hard to say who you have to stop because there is not the Davante Adams effect among these guys. And for Christian Watson, his hamstring has stopped him more than defenses have. So I'm really eager if they solve this issue. And he went to our alma mater this offseason here to get help from the UW with his hamstring issues. One of their doctors there received some of the NFL money to study hamstrings. He and Eric Stokes both went there. We'll see if that helps them. But I want to say, at least in the red zone, that it's a guy that we barely talked about. Romeo Doubs. Like, if I'm worried about stopping the Packers from scoring, he was their best red zone guy. If we're being and we barely even talked to him. I think that speaks to, exactly, Gary, where they're at with their offense. Like, when you said their top three, you said Watson, Wicks, and Reed. You didn't even put Doubs in there, and I can't disagree with you.
Yeah.
Which says something about where they're at with their offense, doesn't it?
It really does. It really, real quick, because you're fast at this, can you pull up the receptions, number of receptions all these guys had last year? How close were they in numbers?
So one of the
problems, I haven't even looked at this year.
Right, and one of the problems, to be sure, was that all the time that Watson missed makes it harder for us to have an idea of exactly what he would look like with a full season, right? So that skews the numbers. But for the 2023 season, Jaden Reed led the Packers in receiving. He caught 64 passes for 793 yards and 8 touchdowns. Next, in terms of receptions and and in terms of yards, Romeo Doubs, 59 receptions, 674 yards, also 8 touchdowns.
Wow.
Now, here's why I like Wicks. Because the first half of the season, he barely got to play. Him and I would say he and Tucker Kraft were the two guys that emerged during that second half of the season. Because Tucker Kraft barely played, too. He was just starting to see his playing time tick up when Luke Musgrave lacerated his kidney. And then he was playing a ton, right? So Wicks was third. 39 receptions, 581 yards, 4 touchdowns. After that, Musgrave with 34, Kraft with 31, Aaron Jones with 30. Christian Watson had 28 catches and 5 touchdowns, averaged a team-high 15.1 yards per catch in his limited time. So I'm eager. Wow. You and I are both very interested to see what Watson can do and if he can stay healthy. Because if he does, then I think, again, he is talented. I know there were people that were saying, oh, they should trade him and he should be part of a trade package. I want to keep him. I want to see what he does with his ability. And if
does it translate, those, when you talk about those reception totals, can anybody catch 75 balls on this team?
Well, the fact that Reed had 64, like, I can see this team having two guys with 75 and another guy with 60, right? It comes down to, what is Doubs' role going to be? Is there, we talk about this competition all the time, is there someone who can take away snaps from him? Like, if Watson is healthy all year and if Wicks is seeing more playing time like he did in the second half of the season, because remember, the other thing about this offense, you talked about the tight ends, I think this offense is at its best when it's changing personnel pretty much every snap.
Absolutely.
Like, the Packers totally went through that phase with McCarthy where they wanted to go no huddle, where they played the same personnel group the whole, and it was great. It worked great with Rodgers, right? But I think with Love and with all these guys, you know, you go 21 personnel, then you go 11 personnel, like that. To me, that's when they're at their best. And so, if you're rotating guys in all the time, and maybe you have Malik Heath, like, there was a time where Malik Heath and Wicks were on the field, it was a run play. Right? Early in the season?
Yeah.
Like, they might as well have announced that they were running the football.
Yep.
And so, I think as those guys develop more, I mean, we saw Heath do more in the passing game than we expected. I mean, he was the guy that was the odd man out late in the year, and he was inactive when he was healthy. So,
well, he was a better run blocker than all those guys.
Right. Right. I mean, he's their new goon, like they had with Alan Lazard. So it'll be interesting to see what it looks like. But I'll say this. I understand why there are people on a national level talking about this team in ways that they were definitely not talking about them a year ago. The Packers are good for national TV programs like and radio shows like Unsportsmanlike and Get Up and all that, because before we were talking about him because of the Aaron Rodgers saga at this time last year. Now we're talking about boy, this offense could be really potent. Gary, I know we have to let you go. You are you have another commitment that you have to leave for. Mm-hmm. I just want to tell you that this, I mean, I suppose I could have worked Thursday and Friday to spend more time with you, but I didn't.
Families first. Families first.
Yeah, important stuff.
His family left him. Like, he was home alone.
I was like, Kevin. It was such a treat to have you as our cousin sub of the day. Thanks for, there were some, I'm not mentioning any names, Rutledge and Hamilton, that weren't even on because they didn't have enough cousin subs to work with. So we thank you for your service, truly, and I'm sure Tausch has more days planned where he's going to be off. So thanks for stepping into the breach, my friend. We appreciate you.
All right. I'm here for you. Appreciate it.
That is the great Gary Ellerson, who was our cousin sub of the day Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Monday, and I'm sure will be again. All right, that's it for the 10 o'clock hour. Jesse and I will kick off the 11 o'clock hour, which will include something interesting that Jesse found audio-wise. We'll hear that, and we'll play some trivia and some Whoa Nelly. That's all ahead in the 11 o'clock hour, so stick around. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at everlightsolar.com.
Hey, this is Eric Name of The Athletic. You're listening to Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN, WTLX Monona, Madison, a Good Karma Brands radio station.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kia of Madison Sports Center.
Good morning, Madison and streamers everywhere. I'm Jesse Nelson, Sports Center, brought to you by A Banner Year, celebrating the 10-year anniversary of the first of the back-to-back Final Four appearances for Wisconsin men's basketball. Catch the debut episode hosted by Ben Brust featuring special guest Bo Ryan tonight at 7 o'clock after the Great Dane Huddle on 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand. Meanwhile, there's only one college basketball team in the state still playing. It's not Marquette after they lost in the Sweet 16 on Friday night to North Carolina State, the Cinderella of the tournament who's now reached the Final Four. No, instead, it's in Madison. Wisconsin women's basketball tonight takes the court at the Kohl Center for the Great Eight round of the women's NIT, hosting St. Louis University. Tip time for SLU and Wisconsin is set for 7 o'clock at the Kohl Center. Meanwhile, Major League Baseball, great start for the Milwaukee Brewers, sweeping the New York Mets over the weekend, including a 4-1 victory yesterday afternoon at Citi Field. The Brewers start 3-0 for the first time since 2018. They return to AmFam Field for the home opener tomorrow afternoon, 3:10 first pitch, hosting the Minnesota Twins.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
Wilde and Tausch begins now without Gary Ellerson, our cousin sub of the day. Jesse, I got a few messages on Thursday and Friday.
That doesn't sound good.
Some positive, some not. How did things go on Thursday and Friday?
We had a good time. I love working with Gary. I said this to Gary when we were starting our show on Thursday that I grew up listening to Gary, and so to be able to host a couple of shows with him was really cool for me. It was a special opportunity, and you know, I love working with Gary. He's awesome. He had some great insight, and when we stumbled our way into fielding stories of fans staying home alone, unattended, and Home Alone situations gone wrong. We had a ton of fun reviewing all that on Thursday. Plus, a lot of great guests joined us on Friday. Domofsky was awesome. We had a great couple of shows.
What did Domofsky talk about? I haven't gone back on Wisconsin On Demand. I saw we've got a story that he wrote for ESPN.com that we're going to tackle tomorrow upon Tausch's scheduled return. What did old Demo have to say?
So I thought the most interesting thing that Rob shared with us, we were talking about the NFL owners meetings and how Matt LaFleur was surprised by Aaron Jones' departure and Josh Jacobs' incoming into Green Bay this year. And he shared this insight that it's not necessarily a bad thing that Matt LaFleur and Goody are on different wavelengths with that at times. Because Goody's job is to make sure that the team stays consistently, you know, in the mix for next year, 3 years, 5 years, 10 years down the line. And on the other hand, Matt LaFleur, if he were the GM, he would want to field the team that's going to be most competitive for right now this year. And he's kind of got that short-sighted nature to it, as most head coaches do. And he said that's why Mike Sherman failed as a head coach in the end, because the general manager, Mike Sherman, got in the way of the head coach, Mike Sherman. Well, that was fascinating for
Rob. Yeah, that's great. Yeah, way to go, Rob. Really good. Nice work. I don't...
What?
All right, so I don't disagree with what Rob said. He's exactly right. But I don't... Again, I don't want to sound like Tausch. No blank blank. He's right. The GM's job is to make sure that they are competitive, not just this season, but every season. And he's right. That was Mike Sherman's downfall, because the coach and the GM sometimes have diametrically opposed goals. My issue is not with their decision to move on from Aaron Jones, even if Matt LaFleur wanted him on the team still. If that's what you think is the best decision and you're in charge of the 53-man roster, then in the end, you do what you think is right for the team, because you're the GM in charge of personnel. My issue is, and again, bias, totally open and honest about. I think Aaron Jones earned the opportunity to be a guy that they kept a year too long, as opposed to getting rid of him a year too early. That is my bias on him. That said, my issue is not that they moved on from him. My issue is with the fact that while you are changing starting running backs, your head coach has no freaking idea that you're doing it. And for him to say that at the coach's breakfast, I know that according to the Athletic's reporting, it was on Friday that they had kind of reached this impasse with Jones, and they didn't think he was going to take the pay cut they wanted. I think he and Drew Rosenhaus came back with a counteroffer. They said, no, thank you for your service, and then pivoted to Josh Jacobs. My issue is not that they chose, that Goody and the personnel staff chose Josh Jacobs over keeping Aaron Jones. That is not my issue. I disagree with it. I would have loved to have seen them both, and I still believe financially that this idea, the cap is an excuse only when you want to use it to justify a guy not being on your team anymore. Right? I mean, let's be honest. At this point, with the it went up $30 million this year. If you wanted both Jones and Jacobs on your team, you could have done it. The cap ramifications weren't that brutal. Now, that said, my issue is not with that choice. My issue is, how the hell do you not let your coach know at some point during that process? What I said to Strofe when he and Molly Brown were filling in on Rutledge and Hamilton the other day was, how long does it take to send a text? 10 seconds? Hey, Matt, things are moving quickly here. Aaron passed up on our offer. We're pivoting. We're going to go after Josh Jacobs. Boom, done. And then Matt LaFleur's not sitting at the coach's breakfast and rap sheets coming over to him. And he's saying, yeah, it's funny you ask that, because I was kind of blindsided by that. If you're functioning as a good company, I don't care if you're selling widgets or doing a radio show or running a football team, someone in that capacity like Matt LaFleur should probably at least know that you're doing it before it happens. That's all. So Rob is right. I pretended like Rob didn't know what the hell he was talking about, but he obviously does. He's fantastic. But the idea that they moved on from Jones is not the issue to me. And moved on to Jacobs is not the issue to me. It's that your coach didn't know you were doing it in real time. That's all. Am I being unreasonable?
I don't think you are. No. I don't know how free agency negotiations work. Like, I don't know how fast
it can't be
move.
That fast.
I don't know. Like, I'm banking on everybody else being able to tell me that. But I would think you would be able to send a quick text saying, just so you guys know, looking at doing this, any objections? Just, you know, real quick, and even a way to make it seem like it's Matt LaFleur's idea. Hey, you would want Josh Jacobs if we could get him, right? Seems like a pretty good pickup, huh?
Before they played the Raiders in October, he was gushing about Josh Jacobs. So, yeah, like, again, did Matt LaFleur want Aaron Jones on the 2024 Green Bay Packers? I think so. Is Matt LaFleur happy to have Josh Jacobs on the 2024 Green Bay Packers? I think so.
Yeah, yeah.
So
I hope so.
I think he legit. Like, I don't think that's a phony. Like, oh, they cut my guy, so I have to pretend like I like Josh Jacobs. Like, I think he's excited about what Josh Jacobs can do, and I think he also, based on some of the things he said at the NFL meetings, I think he also thinks that he has some ideas for how Josh Jacobs can be used that the Raiders didn't use him that way. So I think that he is authentically excited about what he can do with Josh Jacobs. Maybe I'm being obtuse. I just don't understand how he... That just seems like a... We're not talking about, hey, we've decided to move on from Josiah DeGuara. Like, and again, I just bring him up because he's Gary's guy. But like, okay, maybe I can see how you didn't quite communicate that in real time. You know, he's got an offer from the Jaguars. We're not going to match it. You know, fine. I think you should communicate that too. I think the head coach should be looped in on everything. And you should want his input. It's kind of like we talked about once upon a time with Mike McCarthy, and Tausch would say, you can disagree, but you can't be disagreeable. That's what Mike McCarthy used to say. He would take players' input. Tausch delivered it himself. He was on the leadership council. But that didn't mean that Mike McCarthy just did whatever the players wanted him to do all the time. So you can disagree, but once a decision's been made, you can't be disagreeable. So Matt LaFleur can disagree that the personnel department decided to move on from Aaron Jones, but he should at least be part of the discussion and then be let in on the fact that things are changing. That was all my argument was.
What did you think of the argument? And I forget if you were the one who brought this up or Rob or somebody else that I may have
People
heard.
Get us confused a lot.
Yeah, it does happen. The argument that Matt LaFleur may not want to know some of that stuff so that if it happens or it comes out that there were these negotiations, that he can take the side of the players that he works with on a day-to-day where Goody is more removed. So, like, if Aaron Jones ends up coming back on a pay cut, LaFleur can walk up and say, hey, Aaron, like, really appreciate you doing that. I don't know what Goody was thinking, trying to go and get somebody else. You're the guy for us. Like, he can kind of separate himself and have that better, I guess, relatability, connection with the players that he's in there every day with, as opposed to Goody, who has this, I believe you're the one who said this when you joined us on Thursday, he has that kind of separation and right. He looks
Billy
at
Bean.
It more of
Billy
a,
Bean in, yeah. In Moneyball. Yep.
Number 81 as opposed to, you know, Josiah DeGuara.
I think I agree that there is something to that. I'll give you an example. So in both 97 and 98, when you were just a wee lad, the Packers franchise tagged back-to-back their two biggest offensive weapons. In 97, it was, or I guess it was technically 98, it was after the 97 season, it was Dorsey Levens. And then in 99, after the 98 season, it was Antonio Freeman. And in both instances, Mike Holmgren was the coach in 98, Ray Rhodes was the coach in 99, but they were both able to take the side of the player. Right? I want Doris in here. He's so important to what we do, Mike Holmgren is saying. You know, I hope it gets all worked out. I'm not involved with that. If I was in charge, I would give him whatever he wants. right? Ray Rhodes could say the same thing about Freeman. And so it allowed Ron Wolf to be the quote-unquote bad guy. So that is true. But again, that's not what we're talking about here. Like, you can have the conversation with Matt LaFleur in which he can say, look, I understand we have cap ramifications. I really want Aaron Jones on this team. If you can find a way to make it happen, make it happen. But you're the one who makes the final decision. To me, that still gives him the plausible deniability with the player. If Aaron Jones comes back and, look, I didn't want you to have to take a pay cut. I'm just glad you're here. I wanted you here. So, again, I agree that there is a value in that. I agree with Rob's point about the importance of thinking globally and beyond just this season and his comments about Mike Sherman, who was a lovely fellow but a terrible GM and a good coach, by the way. Like, Rob probably said this to you on Friday. The GM, Mike Sherman, the GM, killed Mike Sherman, the coach.
Yep, that's almost verbatim what he said.
And so, see, we do think alike, him and I. So my,
there it is.
I those are all true. That's still not an excuse for the head football coach not knowing that they were swapping out the running backs. It's just not. It's just not. Not in 2024. Maybe in 1963 when people didn't have cell phones and you were moving on from Jim Taylor. Right? But
so,
not now.
Just so we're covering all the bases, is there any reason Matt LaFleur would say that if it wasn't true?
I don't think he would say that publicly that.
I can't think of a reason that he would. Like, there's no benefit to doing that gives you a better relationship with Josh Jacobs or Jordan Love or anything of that. Like, there seems to be no reason if it wasn't true.
I mean, again, I don't think him lying publicly is ever a good idea. Now, I will say, if you remember, and I know this was a was this the train wreck or was it? No, it was the year before that was the train wreck. When Matt LaFleur was on the show after the 2020 draft, he could not wait to publicly disavow the Jordan Love pick.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Which I don't think was completely honest at the time. I think he kind of tap danced along the lines of and blurred the truth line. Because he needed to be on the same page with the starting quarterback. And so I understood why he did it. But I think he liked the pick more than he actually let on. And he was kind of walking it back with us. Remember that?
Yep.
That was very noticeable to me in that conversation.
Yeah, and if there's an advantage to doing it as a leader or as a coach or whatever, like, I understand. Like, I might not like it, but I understand why he would do it. That's why I asked the question, because I just, like, it's possible, and I've heard a couple of people say, well, maybe he just said that because he wanted to. Like, it might not have been true. Maybe he knew and he just didn't want to say that he knew because he didn't want to let Aaron Jones go that way. But I don't see, like, Aaron Jones is gone. He's on the division rival now. Like, there's no reason to protect that
Correct. At
this point.
Yeah, I don't think he lied about this. Because you're right. There's no upside for him. In fact, if we're being really realistic, it makes him look like kind of a doofus who the GM doesn't even give a damn whether or not he knows what's going on. Right? So I don't think he would lie to make himself look bad.
Right.
So, but it's a good question, Jesse. It is. All right, we need to play some trivia. Jesse, I assume that with your busy schedule, you didn't have any Broadway musicals to attend last night.
None this weekend.
You were able to put together the sports weekend recap trivia?
I did not watch a second of the Elite Eight games on Sunday. I did hear a little bit of when the Filipowski foul out and the technical foul on the NC State. I heard
Weenie.
I had to beg to listen to the end of the Elite Eight game on the drive home from our Easter celebration yesterday. So that's where we were at in the car yesterday. But the rest of the weekend, I did watch a lot of basketball. So yes, the sports weekend recap does take center stage for trivia today.
All right. So we will take caller 10. For the sports weekend recap trivia, caller 10, 844-770-3776, 844-770-3776, caller 10 to play Wilde and Tausch trivia next. Want to remind you, I tell you about them all the time. I hope you never need to make the one call, that's all. I hope I never have to make the one call, that's all. That means that we have never, or someone we love has never been injured in a serious accident. I hope that's the case. But it's reassuring to know that David Gruber and Gruber Law Offices are there if you ever need them. Again, I hope you never do. But if you do, go to gruber-law.com to find out more about the firm, about their lawyers, about their history, about what they do in our community. And if you need to make that call, make it. One call, that's all. 414-276-6666, 414-276-6666. Gruber Law Offices, one call, that's all. One call for you will be caller 10 to play trivia next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Mark Tauscher here for Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie, the name you can trust. Well, it's the time of the year when everybody is thinking about travel. Whether you're still finalizing details for a spring getaway or you're already on to thinking about where you'll be heading for a summer road trip, don't let vehicle maintenance be what slows you down. Make sure your vehicle is in its best shape possible every time you're getting ready to hit the road by stopping in to see the amazing service team at Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie. Routine maintenance is critical for keeping your vehicle in the best shape possible. Oil changes, tire rotations, tune-ups, and so much more. Get it checked out before you hit the road so you're not stranded when you're away from home. And if you're in the market for a vehicle upgrade, check out Zimbrick Chevy's new and used vehicle inventory. You can start your search by logging on to ZimbrickChevrolet.com. Stop into Zimbrick Chevrolet on Main Street in Sun Prairie and discover this great automotive team I've been telling you about for years. Consistently recognized as a best of Madison operation, Zimbrick Chevrolet on Main Street in Sun Prairie, the name you can trust.
Evan, Canty, and Michelle are unsportsmanlike.
What's Vegas Midwest?
Madison, where I went to college, is very fun. It, you know that, Smalls. You've been there.
It's not Madison.
It's not Madison. You love Madison.
I love Madison. It is not Las Vegas. It is not Central Vegas.
So is there no Central Vegas then?
Unsportsmanlike. Weekdays from 5 to 9 on 100.5 ESPN.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
Get the beat of the Bucks straight from a fan favorite and Bucks legend. Tap into Hear District with Marcus Johnson, a Bucks Plus audio production. Your weekly pulse on the Milwaukee Bucks and conversations with the biggest names in basketball. This week, Marcus and his son Chris are joined by Bucks radio voice Dave Kane.
I think that stuff's important for them, but there's also you can't be speaking over the heads of a big chunk of your audience that maybe doesn't know that.
So. Find Hear District now on Bucks.com/plus, the Bucks app, or wherever you get your podcast.
From color-changing alexandrite to shimmering zircon and everything in between at Chalmers Jewelers, you'll find high-quality, affordable, one-of-a-kind pieces. We source straight from the gem cutters, and we manufacture in-house from start to finish. As the manufacturer, we believe in truth in pricing. Never pay more for quality and stunning, beautiful jewelry. She's one-of-a-kind, and so should her jewelry be. While others may send your jewelry dreams to someone else to make, with us, your dreams become reality with the help of our custom jewelers, with you involved the whole way. With a staff that has over 200 years of combined experience, why buy from a place that marks up jewelry made by the thousands? When you can buy direct from Chalmers for that one-of-a-kind piece that is better quality, often for less.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
You're probably being overwhelmed with information about semaglutide, the game-changing FDA-approved weight loss treatment. Jim Rutledge here. I was like you. I didn't know what it was until I saw Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health. He can walk you through the benefits. He can tell you if it's right for you, and then you could come up with a plan to change your life with a workout plan and semaglutide. With that plan, I dropped 20% body fat to 10% body fat, and I dropped over 20 pounds of fat and kept my muscle. You can do the same thing. Go see Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health.
Wilde and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
Dancing on the edge.
So, Jesse, I assume you pulled a winner on Friday and didn't forget, right? Because otherwise we've got a conflict of interest here.
We did pull a winner on Friday, yes. Do I remember who it was off the top of my head? No, I do not.
But you can say definitively that it was not Mike and Franklin.
I can definitively, and I can, how could I forget who won trivia on Friday?
Was it Scuba Chad? Making up for the fact that I did not allow her into the Gruber Loft's One Call That's All studios while I was in Milwaukee. Mm-hmm. Congratulations, Jackrabbit Mama, on
winning
trivia.
First-time winner. Yep, that was a big one for Jackrabbit Mama.
So Mike and Franklin, was he a first-time contestant on Thursday, or has he played many times?
No, he's a regular. He knows the drill around here.
He's a regular. He's dialed in, some might say. He is our contestant. Let's play some trivia. Let's welcome Mike in. Mike, good morning. How are you?
Good morning, guys. I'm going to confirm Jackrabbit Mama did win on Friday.
thank you for your reporting. We appreciate that. How are things in Franklin? How are the Sabres?
Oh, they're doing okay. We took second in state football. They did all right.
Nice. All right. Well, let's play some trivia, and we'll see if you can fare as well as the Sabres did in state football. Question number one in the sports weekend recap is this. Which of these was confirmed by the NCAA as a logistical issue during the Women's Elite Eight game played in Portland yesterday? I don't know this answer. I mean, I see the answer, but I don't know this. Was it the length of the three-point line, the speed of the shot clock, or the temperature of the nacho cheese at the concession stands?
I'm going to go with the shot clock.
That's what I would have guessed, too. And I would have been wrong. Jesse, fill me in on this. I missed this
How
story.
How did you miss? It's crazy. So they play yesterday. NC State and Texas are playing in the Elite Eight.
NC State won. Both their teams are in the Final Four.
Which is unreal, because neither of them should have been in the Final. It's unreal what NC State has been on the run of in the last month, both men's and women's. So NC State, Texas are playing. And everybody's commenting on social media. That's why, like, the three-point line on the left side of the court looks shorter than the other side. So they went out and measured it, apparently, during the game. And they, the left side of the court was shorter. It was like the old women's three-point line from a few years ago. The right side was the updated version.
What?
From since they updated it a couple of years. Yeah. So the right side of the court was actually a longer three-point line, the standard three-point line. The left side was shorter. So the teams agreed, let's play through it since we both are shooting on both ends of the court. It'll even itself out. They agreed to play through it. But yeah. It was a total logistical issue with the court in Portland.
I would have been running all. That's nuts.
That's too crazy to be true.
It does. I guess I would have been shooting from the side that was shorter as much as I could.
And to which, there's no way if I'm either of those teams that I'm okay with that. Like, I understand. Like, it's kind of noble in a way that they played through it, but I would have totally said no. That's not okay. Like.
Fix the court.
The team that's playing on the short end in the second half has a distinct advantage by if they know they're down six with a minute left. They can shoot a shorter three than the team on the other end of the court. That's totally unfair.
I mean, I suppose it's a matter of inches, right? Like, it's not a foot.
It wasn't a massive. It was noticeable enough for people watching on TV to be commenting on it.
Not you, though, because you were driving back Easter celebration.
Yes.
All right, let's bounce back. Here's question two. Jesse's got it.
UConn, I get to ask a question. This is fun. UConn went on a 30-0 run between the end of the first half and start of the second half to build its lead over Illinois in the men's Elite Eight on Saturday. As shared by announcer Kevin Harlan during the broadcast, what duration of real time elapsed between Illinois scoring a point in that game? Was it 35 minutes of real time, 50 minutes, or 65 minutes?
I'm going to go with 65 minutes.
This is ridiculous. Mike, I know you didn't win the prize pack, but I hope things went better for you on Thursday, because I watched that game. I don't remember Kevin Harlan saying this. The correct answer was 50 minutes. Yeah. But I do. Okay. We did watch that game.
I knew they ran 30 points in a row. I didn't know what the time span was.
Yeah, it was crazy.
It's been 50 minutes since Illinois last scored a point. That was the big clip that was going around.
Marcus Damask did not score a lot of points during that time.
I was so looking forward to watching that game on Saturday evening, and by the time it got like 4 minutes into the second half, I asked Beck if she wanted to keep watching a show that we'd been watching. I was like, yeah, I'm over it.
UConn looks pretty good. We'll see what they do. All right.
Well, Jason, you missed out on Friday or Thursday when I called, because I told these guys I snuck into Game 5 of the World Series in 1982, but that's another story for another day.
Congratulations on that. You're about to go 0-3 on trivia.
No! Although, if he does go 0-3, I guess Tausch will be happy when he comes back tomorrow that we could go for the imperfect week.
That's true. All right, here you go. Here's your chance to at least get one more entry, Mike. The Milwaukee Brewers, speaking of 1982, the Milwaukee Brewers swept the New York Mets to start the season 3-0 for the first time since which of these seasons? 3-0 for the first time since 2018, 2008, or 1998?
I'm going to go 2008.
You are, and you're going to go 0-3. These were hard.
The difficulty on these questions were pretty tough today.
Yeah.
I didn't think, man. Maybe I just misjudged the population today.
Yeah, I think you might have. All right, Mike, congratulations. You have gotten us off to an imperfect week start of 0-3.
But I still get one chip for calling in, right?
You do get one entry.
And you've set the tone where everyone else can try and match it, and Tausch will be pushing for it starting tomorrow.
Yeah, he definitely will be. We'll see if we can get 12 more incorrect answers the rest of the week. Thanks for playing, buddy. We appreciate your loyalty. Take care.
Yep. Have a good week. Take care.
I love you guys.
Jesse.
You should have heard Hunter's questions the other day.
Oh, no.
We said it wasn't Gerald Ford, but it might as well. It was more obscure than Gerald. We did Brewers trivia on opening day. Brewers trivia. Just throw some Brewers questions out. Robin Yount,
right.
Paul
Molitor,
Ryan Braun. Yolish Chacin was one of the answers.
Yeah, that's not good.
Yolish Chacin, which ironically was, I think, 2018 or it might have been 19. But
great name.
Unreal. Yeah, it was. So even today's may not have been my best work, but significantly upgraded from Yolish Chacin being part of Brewers all-time trivia.
We've had a bit of a run, because before that, it was young Riley Yauch, famous love letter writer, longhand with a quill, like Alexander Hamilton, who one day did not just UFC trivia, but like largely obscure UFC trivia. Like, if you're going to do UFC trivia...
Mm-hmm.
I'm thinking like Conor McGregor should be an answer at some point.
You would think. Yeah, you would think.
But I think Ron in the Key was the contestant that day, and I think he got one right. Rick Rufus, I believe, was the correct answer. Yeah, we need to remember that this is for entertainment, and maybe remember that it's more fun for people to answer questions correctly.
The length of the three-point line's been a pretty significant story.
For the first question out of the gates?
Might have. I could have gone more obscure.
I see that as number two. Yeah.
I did go nacho cheese temperature, which was a little, I could have done something more obscure than the shot clock speed.
That's fair. Well, trivia's over. Jesse, crack open a Coors Light at Tausch's behest. Kick your feet up. Rest for 4 minutes. Get ready for Whoa Nelly, which is coming up after Tausch tells us about the Blue Mountains of Coors Light.
Mark Tauscher here for the Blue Mountains of cold, refreshing Coors Light. Whether you're celebrating your favorite team winning or
You just need a moment to chill. Crack open a Rocky Mountain Cold Coors Light. Coors Light is brewed with a three-step cold process, cold lager, cold filtered, and it is cold packaged, so it is actually made to chill. The mountains on Coors Light's cold-activated bottles and cans turn blue when chilled to perfection, which, besides the refreshing taste, is my favorite thing about drinking Coors Light. Refreshingly cold and only 102 calories, Coors Light is made to chill. Celebrate responsibly. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado.
This is Wilde and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
If you're an employer looking to tap into the next strong generation of local prospective employees, then you can't miss this. 95.3 WBEV ESPN Beaver Dam and DailyDodge.com will be hosting the South Central Wisconsin Career Expo on April 23rd. From 9:30 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the Beaver Dam High School Fieldhouse, businesses will have the opportunity to meet with hundreds of eager juniors and seniors from area high schools, as well as adult job seekers. Employers can find more information and purchase a booth on the Career Expo page at DailyDodge.com.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
The Packers Tailgate Tour is coming to Sun Prairie on Friday, April 12th to help support Sunshine Place, a nonprofit community resources center dedicated to household stability in Sun Prairie and Eastern Dane County. Sunshine Place provides meals, clothing, and living supplies, along with a wide array of social and community services to community members facing food insecurity and other hardships. Join the Packers Tailgate Tour in supporting Sunshine Place of Sun Prairie and Dane County. Visit sunshineplace.org to learn more.
Stoughton Health, in collaboration with patient and family advisors, seeks to advance the healthcare experience at Stoughton Health by providing a forum for past patients and families to provide feedback on a variety of healthcare and other related topics. Advisors offer constructive feedback on their personal journey at Stoughton Health, helping to elevate the patient experience and increase satisfaction. Interested? Please call Amy at 608-873-2308.
What is a better buying experience? Well, you're minutes away from a better buying experience at Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb. Jim Rutledge here. To me, a better buying experience is a personal experience. That's what Dan and his sales team have set up at Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb. You're going to have the experience that you're looking for. You're going to define what that better buying experience is for you, and they're going to get you in the vehicle that you need and that you want, whether it's new or new to you. So when you're looking for a better buying experience, go to Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb.
All you have is one. One chance after an accident. One decision on who to call. One shot to get the help you need. Don't waste it on the one offer you get from your insurance company. Make the one call to Gruber Law Offices. It's the only one you'll need to make. Call us today. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Hi, I'm Medicine Money Guy Christian Finfrock with Retirement Income Strategies. And what sets us apart is we're an independent, family-run office. We help clients like you understand the financial world and build a portfolio that's in your best interest. To learn more, go to MedicineMoneyGuy.com.
For official rules and more information about every contest on 100.5 ESPN, visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com. That's ESPNWisconsinContest.com. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN app.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
It's a beautiful day. Sky falls, you feel like it's a beautiful day.
really, really bad for Mike. That was tough.
The text line disagrees.
How many texts did you get that said it wasn't that hard?
Let me pull them up here. Mike the Wedding DJ chimed in. Johnny, questions were fine. Not to toot my own horn, I would have gone 3 for 3.
Oh, that's some horn tooting right there.
Yeah, there's a couple others saying those weren't that bad. It's getting after me a little bit. Mm-hmm.
I can see knowing the 30-0 run. The timing of it, I'm not sure about. But, hey, it's all past us now. Time now for Monelli.
Topic is good. The guys discuss.
Just the other morning, I had breakfast at Tracy Rucker's house. His mama brought out 15 flapjacks. He said, mama, take back 5 of them flapjacks. I gotta stay hungry for the Crimson Tide.
But if it's not, the show must go on. It's time for...
Whoa, Nelly!
On Wildy and Tausch.
So an age-old question that we typically get to ask about the Green Bay Packers or the Milwaukee Brewers playoff disappointments... The Marquette Golden Eagles fall in the Sweet 16 to DJ Burns and the North Carolina State Wolfpack. A two-part question, actually, both inspired by some of the previous seasons that we've talked about. Question number one, was this season a success for Marquette men's basketball?
God, I hate this. You know I hate this.
Reaching the Sweet 16, advancing further than they have since 2013. Mm-hmm. Best tournament run in over a decade. But losing to a number 11 seed in a game they were favored to win in Dallas with a chance to get to the Final Four looming.
It was a disappointing outcome, but a successful season. And quite frankly, you can't win when you're 4 of 31 from three-point range.
That was so bad. 4 of 31.
And so, it's the same with the Badgers, right? It was at a different point in the tournament, obviously, so it sucks a lot worse. But, like, when your offense can't put the ball in the basket, or in the Badgers' case, what, they commit 19 turnovers?
Yeah.
Season high?
Can't stay on their feet, committing fouls, turnovers.
Like this is the problem with Judge and Craig and I and our good buddy Kyle Wallace, who is on, like, everything. He's on The Truth. He's on KBN. He produces Sunday Karma for Craig. You know, he's down on Greg Gard. And I get it. I'm disappointed in the way their season went, too, and you have every right to be frustrated as a fan. But this is the problem with when you have your crappiest game on the most important stage. I don't care if it's the first round or if you're Virginia, who couldn't put the ball in the ocean in the first four game that they lost, or you're Marquette and you go, again, 4 for 31.
Woof.
From three. 4 for 31.
Woof.
That's not good. And so... Yeah, that's the problem. Is you can't, if you have that same performance on a Tuesday night in November, no one cares. But you have that performance in the tournament, everybody sees it, and now they don't know if you suck or not. In Greg Gard's case, like we talked about it after they went to the Big Ten championship game in the tournament, right? They beat Purdue. They beat Purdue, who is now in the Final Four.
Yeah.
No one cares, though,
nope.
Because you lost to James Madison. So, yeah, it's a successful season. It's a really craptastic ending for Shaka Smart and his guys. You know, you can't... I love Tyler Kolek. Tyler Kolek was 1 for 5 from three-point range. Cam Jones was 3 of 12. That's your 4 three-pointers made from those two guys. Who shot a combined 4 for 17 from three-point range?
Woof.
Next.
Whoa, Nelly!
So then the other question for Marquette fans, or those of us who jumped on the bandwagon, does it make you feel better that Marquette lost to NC State, who then beat Duke and is the Cinderella of the tournament, now reaching the Final Four to play Purdue next weekend? I would say yes.
I don't know how that works. This is a conversation we've had many times before. You're right. usually with the Packers.
Yeah, but Brewers also every year till last year they lost to the team that won the World Series.
Every time except that one.
Except for that one time. No, yeah.
I would think that on the flip side of that coin, if you're Marquette, you're thinking, well, let's see, we lost by 9. We couldn't hit the broadside of a barn shooting threes. If we even shoot, because let's add 4 3-pointers made. 8 for 31 still sucks. And so you're thinking, huh, we could be playing in the Final Four had we not been able to make a shot from beyond the arc to save our lives. So, again, I don't know how Marquette fans are processing this defeat. I would think that they're more likely thinking, they're not thinking, oh, well, we would have lost to Duke anyway. That's for sure. They're thinking, God, if we could have made some shots, we'd be in the Final Four right now.
Whoa, Nelly!
The fact that Duke shot as poorly as they did yesterday, too, makes me think, well, maybe NC State figured something out defensively. They were a pretty good defensive team. Yeah.
All about the drop coverage.
Burnsy.
Got to get Justin Garcia in here to explain that to me.
I wonder how much Tausch has actually watched at the NCAA tournament, but I also wonder how he feels about DJ Burns, because he's got to think that he's his next guy, like Jokic. He's just got to think it, right? Everybody's nationally now, they're saying, oh, this guy could, he could, after the Final Four and potentially a national championship, he could do a little workout for a pro day, and he could be an offensive tackle.
By the way, Marquette loses to NC State. DJ Burns in that game, 4 points. Four.
Yeah. Not his finest outing.
No, but they still won because DJ Horn had 19. They are, I'll say this, I can't believe that they have won now 9 in a row. What a great story, because they have no business being in the tournament.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it was it Virginia that choked against them with a double-digit lead?
Yep.
Like, they don't even belong here, and now they're in the Final Four, and we get to know. I would have not, look, I like to have basketball on in the background during college basketball season. I would have never in a million years known anything about DJ Burns.
Nope.
And now I'm glad I do. Because that is, he's what Tausch was probably as a high school player.
Whoa,
big fella.
Nelly.
Big fella
great
down
feet.
Low.
Nice touch.
Yeah, footwork. A lot of footwork.
Yep.
All right, last up. We went to Easter yesterday, celebrating with my extended family, many of which had not yet met our dog, Mo. My cousin, who was hosting, had met Mo, and her daughter loved playing with him when he was a little bit younger of a puppy, a couple of months ago. So we got the text to come to Easter about 2 weeks ago. And in the text said, please feel free to bring Mo.
Hmm.
We brought Mo, and it turns out their yard was still pretty soggy from the rain Friday.
Uh-oh.
And Becca and I, Easter was kind of a bust because we spent almost all of it outside with the dog because we didn't want to bring him in and deal with the muddy paws inside. And one of my cousins walked up with a white sweatshirt on. Mo jumped up to say hi.
Nice!
Like a good boy. Got the muddy paws all over the sweat. So he kind of caused a little commotion right away. It wasn't a good idea. We probably shouldn't have brought him. We thought in the morning we shouldn't bring him, but no, they want us to bring him. Let's bring him. If someone says, please feel free to bring blank, whether it's a food item, a beverage, or a living creature, are you obligated to bring that thing to the gathering?
Obligated, no. But to put a bow on this, had someone said, please feel free to bring the girls
right,
to the reception so they can dance the night away.
You're the expert on this. Yep.
I would have probably brought them because they love a good wedding. They would have enjoyed dancing the night away at the Tundra Lodge. So I would say when someone says, feel free, it's certainly your call ultimately. But they are sending the message that Mo is welcome. And so I would love to have Mo come. So they would like you to bring him. But you could have exercised some measure of judgment given the weather and the muddy paw situation.
Yeah.
But I think you made the right call. And look, dirt comes out of white sweatshirts.
Yeah.
That sweatshirt's not ruined.
It was fine. We were all fine. It was just bad for many people meeting him for the first time. They thought he was a bad dog because he jumped up and got mud all over the sweatshirt. He was just excited.
So
to
you're
say
worried
hi.
About his reputation?
Yeah, he's got a rep to uphold here, and now everyone thinks, oh, that dog. They brought the dog, and he's getting everything dirty, and they got to stay outside with a ruined Easter.
Well, he didn't ruin Easter. I mean, Judas ruined Good Friday, maybe, but or Maundy Thursday. But I don't think Mo ruined Easter. He still rose from the dead, not Mo, Jesus. I'm glad you brought him. And I'm sure the girl was very happy he was there.
Yeah, everybody had fun. Like everyone, and quite frankly, it was kind of hot in the house, so most people came outside and they wanted to play with him a little bit anyway. So we got to see everybody and talk to them. It wasn't that bad, but we just didn't get to. We had this whole plan to take him in, give him a bone to chew while everyone's eating dinner, pet him, all the fun things, and instead we just kind of sat outside for 3 hours with the dog.
So here's the real important question. We're going to do the show in Sun Prairie during the Packers tailgate tour. Will Mo be available to make an appearance while we do the show?
I guess it depends if whoever's hosting us says, please feel free to bring dogs, and then we'll have to go through this whole thing all over again.
I don't know if the hosts will say that, but I could tell you this host would say that. I'd like to meet Mo, so we'll see if that plays out. All right, that's it for Woe Nelly. Jesse and I will wrap things up. Let's circle back to the text messages. Were there any other people or teams that people root against that we didn't cover that ground earlier in the show? We'll check that out to wrap things up next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
Step into nostalgia with the Miller High Life Dive Bar of the Week. Listen to Rutledge and Hamilton every Thursday, and we will let you know where you can enjoy $2 Miller High Lifes. To celebrate our love for dive bars, me and Matt are going to tell you about some of our favorites, featuring one extra special dive bar that will have $2 High Lifes on special for the week. Taste the champagne of beer in its natural environment. A delightfully different dive bar in Wisconsin, like Rip's Bar in Wanakee, Paul's Neighborhood Bar, Villa Tap, and Nitty Gritty in Sun Prairie.
You, rah-rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Stroff.
This Badger Minute brought to you by the Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's home for craft beer and pub food since 1994. Find the Great Dane nearest you at greatdanepub.com. Three-star defensive lineman recruit in the class of 2025, Torin Petaway of Middleton High School, flipped his commitment from Wisconsin to rival Minnesota last week. Petaway committed to the Badgers in early March after receiving offers from Big Ten schools like Rutgers and Minnesota, but decommitted Thursday night shortly before tweeting 100% committed to coach PJ Fleck and the Minnesota Gophers. The Badgers still have plenty of time to fill their needs prior to next year's National Signing Day, which is not until February 5th of 2025.
Badger Minutes on ESPN Wisconsin are brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Schedule an appointment online today at PellaWI.com.
Hey, hungry? And your heart is ticking for chicken? Well, take a quick turn into Quick Trip, because we got
no ordinary chicken.
Yeah, go wild with wings. Next level super wings with trusty Sidekick and sauces. Or let's talk tender. Quick Chick tenders. Love me tenders. Love me some Quick tenders. Ours are bigger, better, tastier. Or if you're feeling good old school comfort fried chicken, we got it. Hand breaded down homier than anywhere. Quick Trip. Saving your nuggets from ordinary.
Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance. And you can weather any storm. You'll also save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote. Find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution, bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit CelebrationsEntertainment.com. That's CelebrationsEntertainment.com.
You're back at the gym. Your new gym outfit? On point. Your new sneakers? Baller. You've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with Access Checking. It's maintenance fee free with no minimum balance requirements. So when you take your first yoga class in 10 months, your body might surprise you, but your checking account won't. You've got this with Access Checking from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
From the preps.
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros.
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
Show talking about teams or people we root against, and full disclosure, I'm going to be watching Iowa LSU tonight, and I like Flauje Johnson. I don't like Kim Mulkey, so I don't want Kim Mulkey to win. Sorry, she's a bully. Don't like her. Love her sequins, but don't like her. I don't feel strongly about Caitlin Clark, but I like watching her play. I think she sets a great example for Sid. So we will be watching, but I hope Iowa wins. Is that? I don't think that makes me a bad person, Jesse.
No. I thought this when we were in Dubuque watching the first round of the NCAA women's tournament games that were up. LSU is like a super villain. Like Kim Mulkey wearing her outlandish outfits. If you want like a heroes and villains story,
she's
like,
Cruella DeVille.
She's like the big bad horrible person villain in like a spy thriller. And Caitlin Clark is like the hero that we all need, trying to like storm the castle to take her down. And Angel Reese is one of the people guarding the door. Like this is such a heroes and villains type story tonight. You got Caitlin Clark in these commercials where she's doing the little heart thing with her mom. And then you got Kim Mulkey slamming every media outlet imaginable and every press. It's heroes and villains to the fullest extent, which is all we ever want from sports. This is going to be amazing tonight.
If you have time before the game, read Kent Babb's piece on Kim Mulkey. It is really well done, and there are some really interesting parts to it. It's worth your time. It was not a hit piece. It was not. That's it for us today. Thanks to Gary Ellerson for all the time he spent as our cousin sub of the day. Tausch scheduled to appear tomorrow. Have a great day. Take care. Be good.
Miss any of today's episode of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin? Commercial-free full show podcasts are available free.